following is a special presentation of ABC Sports.
Baseball began in a bright green field with an ancient name when this country was new and raw and without shape. And it has shaped America by linking every summer from 1846 to this one through wars and depressions and seasons of rain. Baseball is one of the few enduring institutions in America that has been continuous and adaptable and in touch with its origins. As a result, baseball is not simply an essential part of this country. It is a living memory of what American culture at its best wishes to be.
The table has been set. The annual baseball feast is about to begin. The Oakland Athletics meet the San Francisco Giants in the 1989 World Series, a series that combines nostalgia with tomorrow's legends, a gourmet's delight. Some of the guests were here last year but left with a sour taste. This year they return anticipating champagne. Men like manager Tony La Russa, Jose Canseco, Dave Parker, Dennis Eckersley, and a new invitee who sits at the head of the table. They dream of recapturing the excitement epitomized by another team. So identifiable, only first names and nicknames are necessary. Reggie, Vita, Catfish, Raleigh, the team that won three world championships in a row. The Giants of San Francisco haven't been to this party for years. They last tasted a world title in 1954, when home was on another coast. After three more seasons, with their fans in despair, the Giants moved west to their new home by the bay. Then in 1962, they nearly won the series again. But a Willie McCovey line drive was swallowed up by Bobby Richardson, and it was the Yankees who celebrated. Now the 1989 Giants will try to take that elusive last step under Roger Craig, with a combination of willpower and a powerful supporting cast. Your table is ready, folks. Have a seat and savor.
Welcome to Oakland, California, Game 1 of the 1989 World Series, an aerial view of the Oakland-Alameda County Coliseum, the fifth time the World Series has been held here. They're calling it the Battle of the Bay. They're also calling it baseball, as the San Francisco Giants take on the Oakland Athletics on a cloudy early evening. That'll help the hitters as we take a look at the game time temperature, 58 degrees. There's the humidity. It's a light breeze out of the west, forecast for low clouds in the early evening. I'm Al Michaels. Welcome to the World Series, this great regional battle, the Battle of the Bay. And when you take a look at the West Coast history of these franchises, it's a V-graph. The Giants came amidst great euphoria in 1958. The teams of Mays and McCovey and Marichal, LePennant in 62, but then the bottom fell out in the mid-70s, and the Giants came this close to moving to Toronto. But they were saved by Bob Lurie and his ultimate reward, a pennant in 1989. The A's, meanwhile, came from Kansas City in 1968. They had the great teams in the early 70s, five first-place finishes, three consecutive world titles, but the bottom fell out in Oakland in the late 70s because of free agency. Charlie Finley had to sell. The A's came this close to moving. The Haas family saved them. And so you might say the light at the end of the proverbial tunnel for each franchise is the improbability of meeting in the 1989 World Series as we get set for Game 1. That's the backdrop. Let's talk about the present. Let's talk about pitching. Who better to describe that aspect of the game than Jim Palmer? And certainly the consensus feeling, Jim, is that the A's have a better staff and a deeper staff. What do you think?
Well, I think on paper they do. Tony La Russa, the manager of the A's, 4 starters. Stewart will see tonight 21 wins, then 19 by Davis and by Moore, and 17 by Bob Welch. He's got a deep middle relief, Honeycutt. He can go to Nelson. He can go to Burns. He can go to Young. And then you get to the best right-handed closer, in my estimation, in baseball. Roger Craig of the Giants, on the other hand, well, he's got Garrelts, who was 14-5, led the National League in ERA this year. But Russell's been hurt. He'll pitch the second game with a groin pull. And Don Robinson has been out with a strained ligament. He threw very well in a simulated game. He will be the third pitcher if he's healthy. The rest of it kind of scattered. Bogdrosian, Lefferts, the left and right-hander in the bullpen, and Roger Craig, I will tell you, this is the best condition his staff has been in, so he's ready.
Certainly, every pitcher on each team is thinking about one particular guy on the other side. Let me turn now to Tim McCarver, and let's talk about the marquee guys coming out of the playoffs. Will Clark of the Giants, Ricky Henderson of the A's.
And you can bet both pitching staffs are thinking about those two guys. Phenomenal offensive players, both the most valuable players in the LCSs, but with completely different styles. Ricky Henderson can really run. As a matter of fact, he doesn't have to hit to get on. 7 walks in the LCS, 8 stolen bases, so when he gets on first, for the most part, his job's just beginning. Will Clark, on the other hand, when he gets on first, his job's done, because he has to hit, and can he ever hit? 13-20 in the LCS, and I think the A's have to stop Clark from hitting, and the Giants have to stop Ricky Henderson from running.
Well, as many of you know, it's the first time since 1956, 33 years, we've had what you might call a Subway World Series. It was a true Subway Series in New York in 56. The Brooklyn Dodgers, the New York Yankees, the highlight, of course, Don Larsen throwing a strike past Dale Mitchell there, the only perfect game in World Series history. The Yankees win the title. A subway ride between Brooklyn and the Bronx was 15 cents. In 1989, you can also ride the subway between San Francisco and Oakland. It's called BART, Bay Area Rapid Transit, $2.05 under the bay. The battle by the bay coming up, game one. We'll be back in a moment.
From MCI, proof that commitment to excellence brings out the best.
I like my bottom line. I hate wasting time. I like my MCI. I get more.
Today's union movement is all about giving people a voice in what goes on at work and in supporting one another. I believe in that. I said union, yes.
America works best when we say union, yes.
You think you're better than me, don't you?
Oh, not again. I was better than you in high school. I was better than you in college. And I am better than you now.
There are still some people in this world who can change tax brackets without changing personalities.
You want to put that to a test?
Let's go.
Now?
Now.
For those people, there's a car called the Legend Coupe from Acura. Number one in customer satisfaction 3 years in a row.
It's always
my spine felt like a lightning rod.
Are you feeling okay?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yours are pretty weird.
Life goes on.
Rebecca!
Following the World Series tomorrow.
Monday.
Are you ready, Buffalo Football?
The undefeated Los Angeles Rams tackle the Buffalo Bills on ABC's NFL Monday Night Football.
Then on Bangkok's black market, everything has a price.
You come looking for more trouble?
Not really.
I'm gonna die, pal.
MacGyver.
the 1989 World Series. Brought to you by Acura Legend and Integra. Precision crafted performance exclusively at your Acura dealer. By Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires. And by Head & Shoulders, because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
You know, when you think about Will Clark and Ricky Henderson in the playoffs, not that surprising. Clark had a terrific regular season, finished second to Tony Gwynn in the batting race. Henderson, you'll recall, started the year with the Yankees, traded to Oakland on the 20th of June. He is the once and present A, of course. He started his career here and then came back. And when you take a look at Ricky right there and you look at the numbers that these two fellas put up in the league championship series, Clark hitting 650. Henderson not only 6 for 15, but keep in mind those 7 walks, which led to 8 steals, which led to 8 runs. And, of course, he made life absolutely miserable over a 5-game stretch for the Toronto Blue Jays. As this was an all-too-familiar sight, Ricky Henderson stealing third here. And, of course, a crock for Ernie Witt, the catcher, and when he wasn't walking and stealing or singling and stealing, he was homering, which he did twice in Game 4 in Toronto to lead the A's to a victory. Will Clark in Game 1 of the National League Championship Series hit a grand slam home run. He went 4-for-4 that night, and then, of course, last Monday, game tied in the 8th inning. Mitch Williams on the mound, base hit up the middle to drive in 2 to give the Giants the lead, and eventually the pennant. The final score was 3-2. Well, joining us for our pregame shows will be Gary Thorne and Joe Morgan for the World Series. And earlier, they talked with Will Clark and Ricky Henderson.
Ricky Henderson, in the league championship series, I'm not sure we've seen a ball player play as confidently as you did. Did you feel as confident as you looked?
I feel confident, just being in the playoff. You know, it took me a long time by getting in the playoff, and I was so wound up and doing so well for the team and helping the team get to the World Series based on, because it was something that I dreamed of, getting to the World Series. So I was trying not to let anything get in my way.
Ricky, to all those critics over the years who have said there's an on-off switch on Ricky Henderson, and some days he comes to play and some days he doesn't, how do you respond to that?
I really can't respond to it because I don't recall the days that I come and I goes, oh, I can shut it off, and then days I can come out there and say, oh, you know, I'm going to go 4-for-4 and hit 200 runs. I don't think any ball players have that control on what he can do out on the field. Just based on, I think, the things that, you know, I do probably run so well, and some days maybe I'm not running as fast as I was the other day. People say that you turn it on and off. I just think it's just based on, you maybe went out and stole 4 base that day. You're just a little tired and you try to save yourself for the whole game.
Ricky, thank you. Have a great series. Ricky Henderson of the A's, now Joe Morgan with Will Clark.
Will, during the LCS, you swung the bat as well as anyone I've ever seen. But now you've had 4 days off. Do you think that'll affect your groove?
Well, I'm hoping that it doesn't affect not only my groove, but also the rest of my teammates. I think some guys were starting to swing the bat real well, and 4 days off could hurt.
You know, the last image I have of you is running out that triple and hobbling around the bases. How's the knee?
The 4 days off did help the knee. As far as the swing goes, we got to see.
You know, you guys are the underdog here. What do the Giants have to do to defeat the A's?
Well, we got to go out there and execute like we've been doing all season long, but we got to keep their 1-2 hitters off for the big boppers, so if the big boppers get a hit, they're not going to hurt us.
Good luck.
Thank you.
We're in Oakland for Game 1 of the 1989 World Series, and we'll return after this message and an ABC News brief.
You know what? My dad bought a new car. So did mine. My dad got a V8. My dad got a V12. My dad got a sunroof. My dad got a convertible. My dad got a CD player. My dad got a car for me. My dad got Michelin.
Michelin? Well, my mom's prettier than your mom.
Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Listen to my nephew. He's going to be a lawyer like me. He's even going to look like me.
Oh, really? So does that mean on his first big trial day, the jury's going to notice his winning smile?
Yeah.
And his great suit.
Yeah.
Oh, his little flakes.
No, dandruff, me?
Oh, it can happen to perfect people. Here, just use my shampoo.
Head and Shoulders?
Mm-hmm.
But you don't have dandruff.
I rest my case.
Head and Shoulders, because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
Introducing the 1990 Acura Integra. An automobile that can make getting there considerably more than half the fun.
An ABC News brief. Now from Washington, Sam Donaldson.
Good evening. Top corporate executives meeting in Hot Springs, Virginia, are advising investors not to panic after yesterday's stock market plunge. They call it a market correction. Fire broke out aboard a Delta Airlines jet just after it arrived in Salt Lake City. Six people were hospitalized for smoke inhalation. And Tropical Storm Jerry is still heading for the Louisiana coast, but probably won't strengthen to hurricane force. More news later on the Weekend Report.
And back in Oakland, right now, let's join the public address announcer, Roy Steele.
Okay, Coach. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Game 1 of the 1989 World Series, the Battle of the Bay. At this time, we'd like to introduce the starting lineup for the 1989 National League champion San Francisco Giants. The manager, number 38, Roger Craig. Leading off, number 2, Brett Butler, center field. Batting second and playing second base, number 6, Robbie Thompson. Hitting third, first baseman, number 22, Will Clark. Position, left fielder, number 7, Kevin Mitchell. Hitting fifth and playing third base, number 9, Matt Williams. Hitting sixth, designated hitter, number 1, Ernest Ryles. Batting seventh and playing right field, number 21, Candy Maldonado. Batting eighth and doing the catching, number 16, Terry Kennedy. Hitting ninth, shortstop, number 23, Jose Uribe. In the bullpen, tonight's starting pitcher for San Francisco, number 50, Scott Garrelts. And the remaining players, coaches, trainers, and equipment managers for the San Francisco Giants. And now, your 1989 American League champion, Oakland Athletics. The manager, number 10, Tony La Russa. Leading off, number 24, Ricky Henderson, left field. Second and playing third base, number 4, Carney Lansford. Hitting third, number 33, Jose Canseco, right field. Batting fourth, the designated hitter, number 39, Dave Parker. Hitting fifth, the center fielder, number 42, Dave Henderson. Batting sixth and playing first base, number 25, Mark McGuire. hitting seventh and doing the catching, number 36, Terry Steinbach. Batting in the eighth position, number 2, Tony Phillips, second base. Hitting ninth, number 7, Walt Weiss, shortstop. In the bullpen, tonight's starting pitcher for Oakland, number 34, Dave Stewart. And the remaining players, coaches, trainers, and equipment managers for the American League champion, Oakland Athletics.
Gentlemen, please direct your attention to the center field area as the Naval Air Station color guard from Moffett Field present the colors for tonight's game. Ladies and gentlemen, on September 1st, baseball lost a man who was not only its commissioner, but its best friend. At this time, we ask each of you to observe a moment of silence in which to remember baseball's seventh commissioner, A. Bartlett Giamatti. And now to honor America, please rise and join in the singing of our national anthem as performed by the world-renowned Whiffin' Poops from Bart Giamatti's alma mater, Yale University.
After this message, courtesy of Major League Baseball, and a word from our ABC stations.
Enjoy baseball memories throughout the years by ordering your copy of the 1989 World Series Souvenir Program. Packed with more than 90 pages of features, historical facts, and photos from the Fall Classic, this program is truly a collector's item. To get yours, send check or money order for $6 to World Series Program, Box 89, Trenton, New Jersey, 08651. That's Box 89, Trenton, New Jersey, 08651. Please be sure to include your proper return address. The preceding announcement was furnished by Major League Baseball.
Starting 2 weeks from tonight, four great stars in a series of all-new two-hour mysteries.
Wait till I tell Mrs. Colombo.
For Peter Falk, it's
murder when he returns as Columbo.
Sounds good to me.
And Burt Reynolds is still undercover as Private Eye B.L. Stryker.
I'd like to see a little justice here.
New this season, Jacqueline Smith solving the crimes of the rich and famous as Christine Cromwell.
Oh, the base is covered so far.
And Telly Savalas is back as Kojak. The premiere of the ABC Saturday Mystery in 2 weeks.
Mr. Ian McKenzie.
I'm Angus McKenzie. Yanks moved down the road.
Today, with service to 175 countries.
Oh, you've been wanting in, Alistair McKenzie.
UPS delivers to nearly 4 billion people.
Parcel for McKenzie. Aye.
Including the extraordinary concentration of McKenzies along the northeast coast of Scotland.
Mr. Ian Alistair McKenzie?
No trouble finding me, did you, lad?
No trouble at all.
UPS. We run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
The Honda Accord is a nice car. But the new Hyundai Sonata has a more powerful standard engine. The Sonata also has more interior room. Yet it costs thousands less. Last year, the Accord was the best-selling mid-sized import. This year, who knows? The new mid-sized Sonata from Hyundai. We're making more sense than ever.
I've got a craving that it'd be so nice to get pizza, a hot and juicy slice. I got those gotta have a pizza blues.
Looking for a slice at a great price? Get new piece of pizza at AM/PM Mini Markets. Pepperoni or Supreme Combo, just 89 cents.
Come on, baby, to the right address. Fill up at AM/PM and you'll fill up for less.
Series analysis with Steve Garvey and Todd Donahoe after the game.
An aerial view from above San Francisco, zooming past the Bay Bridge, spanning San Francisco and Oakland and on past Alameda. And in the distance there, the city of Oakland, California, about 350,000 population, beautiful Lake Merritt, this area of nearly 6 million people. And as we pan left, downtown Oakland. This the site for the first and second games of the 1989 World Series. And now an aerial view from above the Oakland-Alameda County Coliseum. The fifth time the World Series has been played here. Welcome to Game 1, the San Francisco Giants against the Oakland Athletics. I'm Al Michaels, and as far as this matchup is concerned, taking a look at what people expected before the season, I think the A's were the consensus pick in the American League, and why not? They won the pennant in 1988, figured to be as strong. They added Ricky Henderson, but the A's will tell you to a man, this one was sweeter. Why? Because Jose Canseco missed half the season because of a wrist fracture. Walt Weiss, last year's Rookie of the Year, missed about half the season with a knee injury, and Dennis Eckersley, the premier relief pitcher, missed about a quarter of the season with an arm injury. And then, of course, they were able to stave off Kansas City and California and beat Toronto in the playoffs. The Giants, meanwhile, figured to finish fourth, according to the experts in the National League West. And if you'd have told Roger Craig before the season he'd have to use 15 different starting pitchers, he'd have probably said, great prediction. I think the Giants winning the pennant might be something only appreciated in retrospect, the way Craig was able to do it. That team never lost more than three games in a row this season. Tim McCarver, let's take a look now at the matchup in terms of the A's, who know they have some unfinished business because they lost to the Dodgers last year. The Giants, a lot of people feel, may be just happy to be here, their first pennant in 27 years. What do you think?
Well, I think the Oakland A's are heavy favorites for several reasons. They've made five changes on their roster, namely Ricky Henderson and Mike Moore. But the biggest reason Oakland's favored in this World Series is they're not facing a dominating pitcher like they were last year. Oral Hershiser, who won two of the four games that the Dodgers won, and the one he didn't win, then you had the miracle storybook home run by Kirk Gibson. So, I mean, the Giants, when you think about it, only named their third starter tonight, and that's next Tuesday, and it'll be Don Robinson.
On the subject of pitching, let's turn to Jim Palmer, formerly of the Baltimore Orioles, no stranger to the Cy Young Award. Of course, Dave Stewart's a stranger to the Cy Young Award. He keeps finishing second. What about tonight's matchup, Dave Stewart against Scott Garrelts?
Well, Tim talked about the fact that they had a dominating pitcher, Hershiser, last year. The Giants hope it'll be Scott Garrelts, number one in the National League in earned run average. They only hit .212 off him, so he can be tough. He's right-handed, a lot of right-handed hitters in the Oakland lineup, so it should be a good matchup. On the other hand, Dave Stewart, baseball's most consistent pitcher over the last 3 years, and he says he's unappreciated. Well, he makes well over $1 million a year, and I don't think Oakland would rather have anybody else on the mound, so it should be a good matchup.
The Battle of the Bay. Glad you're with us. Settle back, game one of the World Series coming up. The San Francisco Giants and the Oakland A's.
Getting to know you, getting to know all about you.
Meet the 1990 Geo.
Getting to like you, getting to hope you like me.
In the 70s, you got to know a small car company called Toyota. In the 80s, Honda. Today, the 90s begin, and we invite you to get to know Geo.
Getting to know you.
At your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Well, fans, it all comes down to this moment. This is where it all gets decided. Johnson steps in, checks the signs, makes a few adjustments. This is a classic confrontation. He's digging in. Here's the delivery. And there it goes. He's going back, way back. It is going, going. It is gone.
Pepsi, a generation ahead.
Every one of these police cars comes on Goodyear Eagles, and only on Goodyear Eagles. Why? Because they want it that way. Goodyear Eagles, there really is a difference.
U.S. Armed Forces. You're in with top quality people and top quality experiences.
Opportunity is waiting for you. In the U.S. Armed Forces, you're in.
It goes with the boys that play in the dirt. It goes with the joy. It goes with the hurt. It goes with the men you can't fix in. It's there when you lose.
Defending Big Ten champ Michigan tackles perennial power Iowa. Or UCLA hits the Oregon Trail to take on Oregon State. Next Saturday on ABC's College Football.
The 1989 World Series. The San Francisco Giants versus the Oakland Athletics. Brought to you by Geo. Get to know Geo. Sold and serviced by Chevrolet Geo dealers. By Anheuser-Busch, we brew our fine quality beers to be enjoyed responsibly. Remember, know when to say when. By the good time, great taste of McDonald's. And by Apple Computer, the power to be your best.
Ready for game one just moments ago, appropriately the ceremonial first pitch of the 1989 World Series, delivered from the mound by Bart Giamatti's son, Marcus. And now we will get officially underway. The wife of the late commissioner on the left, and the Oakland A's have just taken the field for game one. Dave Stewart will be going to the mound. A feature of our World Series coverage again this year will be what we call the inside pitch. So we have gone to Steve Sachs of the New York Yankees, who was a teammate of Dave's with the Dodgers years ago, to give us the inside pitch on Dave Stewart.
Dave Stewart has three basic good pitches that he uses: a fastball, a curveball, and a forkball. Forkball he throws mostly to the left-handed hitters. He's got a tough, herky-jerky motion, so it's hard to pick the ball up coming out of his hand. But, however, Dave does have a problem when he pitches in patterns, and he'll throw the left-handers outside, the right-handers inside. He has a tendency to get into problems wild early in the ballgame. If he does this, the Giants have to capitalize on it, because Dave Stewart is one of the toughest battlers in the league. He's a clubhouse leader, which is really unusual for a pitcher, and he gets very strong as the game progresses.
Dave Stewart, released in 1986, could have signed with anybody. Winds up with the A's, again a 20-game winner, 21-9 during the regular season, 69 walks and 155 strikeouts for Dave Stewart. Take a look again at the San Francisco lineup that he'll face tonight. Brett Butler, Robbie Thompson, and Will Clark. Kevin Mitchell in the cleanup spot. Matt Williams, Ernest Riles, the DH. The pitcher's bat in the National League City, meaning the pitcher's bat in San Francisco in 3, 4, and 5. And Maldonado, Kennedy, and Uribe hitting in the number 9 spot. The A's, very good defensively, with Brett Butler checking out Stewart. And the A's defensively, good outfield with Ricky Henderson in left, Dave Henderson in center, and Canseco in right. Carney Lansford back after the hamstring pull in the playoffs at third. Walt Weiss at short. Tony Phillips at second. Mark McGuire at first. Terry Steinbach is the catcher, Stewart the pitcher, and Brett Butler to start the 1989 World Series. In a way, he is probably the most appropriate player to begin a Bay Area World Series. He spent 12 years living in the East Bay town of Fremont. As a kid, he went to Candlestick Park about half a dozen times a season, and here about 6 to 10 times a season, and grew up as a fan of both teams, much in the tradition of the way the whole Bay Area feels as we get started. This is not a confrontation, this is a love fest. And the World Series is underway. Butler, Thompson, and Clark in the top of the first. Butler, and everybody knows it, loves to bunt. 23 bunt singles, the pitcher's a strike. So he is used to seeing the third baseman in on the grass, as is the case here with Carney Lansford.
And you'll see that even with two strikes, because he's a very good bunter.
Swung lead at a fastball, and the count is 1-2.
In the opening, you talked about the twilight. Stewart with a fastball over 90 miles per hour, a curveball, and a great forkball. Uses that when he gets ahead in the strikes situation with two strikes on, say, Butler.
And the 1-2 pitch is just off the plate, and there it was in the count 2-2. Remains 2-2 on Butler, who plays in the World Series for the first time. Brett came up with Atlanta, then over to Cleveland, and then he became a free agent. And the Giants through the years have had a lot of trouble signing free agents, because a lot of players just don't want to play in Candlestick Park. But Butler, loving the area, seeing the opportunity, signs on and lets a fly ball to center field. Dave Henderson is there. So one center fielder flies out to the other to begin the first inning, and Robbie Thompson comes to the plate. It was a week ago tonight that Robbie Thompson hit a home run that turned out to be the game-winning hit in Game 3 against Chicago.
One of three game-winning hits. The next night, Matt Williams with a two-run homer to beat the Cubs 6-4, and then Will Clark single up the middle off Mitch Williams, and the Giants won it.
He is, of course, anything but your prototype number two hitter, because he has struck out 133 times during the regular season.
Usually the number two hole hitter
is a hitter that makes a lot of contact to move the leadoff hitter along. Thompson with a lot of power, 11 triples, 13 home runs during the regular season. High ball hitter.
The 1-1 to Thompson, breaking pitch over for a strike, 1-2.
And that's the fork ball we're talking about. You can take the tumbling action on the ball, and what sets this up is you look at the fork ball. Of course, they'll call it a fork ball here in Oakland. Over in San Francisco, it's a split finger fastball.
2-2. One out, top of the first. Will Clark on deck. And Thompson is a little dribbler to the left of the mound. And Dave Stewart throws and throws past McGuire with a lot of room in foul territory. Phillips over to play it. And Thompson in at second. So the Giants get a break on a little dribbler that Stewart throws away.
I'll tell you, it looked like Stewart was winding up to throw the ball. He appeared to be pitching the ball to Mark McGuire. You see how he winds up? And now he throws it wild to the inside of McGuire. An error on Dave Stewart.
It's an error all the way, and so Stewart throwing one by McGuire with Thompson now at second base, and that means with a man in scoring position, Stewart has to face Will Clark. And Clark goes after the first pitch, hits it to the gap in left center, but Dave Henderson moves over to make the catch. Thompson is late in tagging and has to hold at second. So Will Clark's first at bat is a sharply hit drive to left center field, but he's gone for the second out.
And it appears, Al, what they're going to do is pitch Clark away. Of course, it's very early, the first at bat, and play him that way. Because Henderson made a nice running catch because he was a couple of steps to left field.
Now Kevin Mitchell comes to the plate. Mitchell leading the majors in homers and in RBIs and hitting 291. And most feel he'll be the National League's most valuable player. And if you're wondering, those votes already in. Playoffs don't count. Series doesn't count. Those votes go in after the regular season. First base open here with Thompson at second, two down, and Matt Williams on deck. In there. Off speed, 1-1. Thompson off to his lead at second. Earlier in the year, it would be an automatic walk here for Mitchell, but now he is backed up by Matt Williams, and that makes a difference. The pitch is a strike, and the count is 1-2. The Giants spent the entire season until Williams came back from Phoenix looking for a number five hitter, somebody to protect Kevin Mitchell. Here's the 1-2 to Mitchell, hit to the right side, and short hop nicely by Phillips to throw him out. And the Giants are gone in the first.
How are things at work, dear? Okay. They want me to use a computer.
A computer? You?
I mean, what do I need a computer for? I'm not an accountant. I figure what? I've been in this business 11 years, right?
Why do I need one now? I've done fine without one.
I'm walking to the office and they have this computer there. Can you imagine me working on a computer?
They figure if you can use one, then anybody can use one.
Macintosh has the power to change your mind about computers. The power to be your best.
So I was wrong.
Scott Garrelts on the mound for the San Francisco Giants, and our inside pitch will be delivered throughout the course of the series. by this year's National League batting champion, Tony Gwynn of the San Diego Padres.
Scott Garrelts is a four-pitch pitcher. Fastball, slider, forkball, and curveball. But the curveball is a pitch that he's prone to make a mistake with. He has to keep the pitch down in the strike zone. His forkball is his best pitch. And even if he makes a mistake with this pitch, it's going to be tough for the hitters to hit. He's good at holding runners on, but he doesn't get rattled. And he's extremely tough on right-handed batters.
And Scott Garrelts, who began spring training in the Giants' bullpen, faces this lineup. Ricky Henderson leading off in left field, and Lansford and Canseco. Dave Parca is the designated hitter. Dave Henderson in center. Mark McGuire batting sixth, with Terry Steinbach hitting seventh. Tony Phillips hitting eighth. And Walt Weiss gets the start at shortstop over Mike Gallego, because Tony La Russa wants to get an extra left-handed bat in the lineup. Ricky Henderson, most valuable player in the American League Championship Series. Obviously, you don't have to be a Rhodes Scholar to know that you don't want to walk Ricky Henderson. And Roger Craig was saying yesterday, hey, I don't have to beat Scott Garrelts over the head with it. The more you talk about it, the more he's liable to think about it. He knows what he has to do.
Well, the thing, the problem for Scott Garrelts is that Ricky Henderson goes up to home plate trying to get to first base. He'll walk, he'll work the pitcher, the umpire, and he will make you throw strikes. So it's not as easy, and then if you get behind him, he becomes a home run threat. Very difficult, as a lot of people have said, maybe the best leadoff hitter in the history of the game.
40 times he has led off a game with a home run and a breaking pitch for a strike, 0-1. For Ricky, his first appearance in a World Series. Came close in 81 with Oakland, but they lost to the Yankees in the LCS. Another strike. Then he went to New York and came back here on the 20th of June in the deal that sent Luis Polonia and Eric Plunk and Greg Catteray to the Yankees.
I think a key during this World Series is to see how many times the Giant pitchers can get in this situation ahead in the count.
1-2.
Because if you're ever going to get Henderson to expand the strike zone, it is when he has two strikes on him. Otherwise, tell you what, he knows what he has to do. He knows he can unnerve you if you walk him, because you've done exactly what you don't want to do.
Grounded through the middle, but Thompson is there to glove it behind second and throw him out. So Robbie Thompson, shading Henderson toward the middle, gets there to take care of Ricky. One away. Funny thing, though, about the A's, it's not just keeping Henderson off base. That's a pretty good rest of the lineup as well.
Well, again, I think one of the reasons Stewart threw the ball away is right here. You see Robbie Thompson's quickness. Quick to get in front of that ball. An outstanding second baseman. He made Stewart hurry the throw in the first. He doesn't run that fast, but he's awfully quick.
Carney Lansford, the batter. He grounds one toward the middle, and Uribe can't flag it. So Lansford, who missed two games against Toronto because of the hamstring, really needed the time off. It has worked to his benefit, and the first hit of the series belongs to Carney.
Carney finishing second to Kirby Puckett in the American League batting race, and Kirby Puckett leading the American League for only the second time as a right-handed hitter in the last 20 years. 1981, Carney Lansford led the American League. Those are the only two right-handed hitters that have led the American League since 1970.
Lansford at first base. Now, Lansford has good speed. He had 37 steals during the regular season, but remember, he's coming back from the hamstring pull. In there for a strike to Canseco, and the count is 1-1.
Tony La Russa, speaking to us before the game, said that ideally he'd like to have a big lead and take Lansford out in the seventh inning to rest the left hamstring.
So many people talking about one of the keys being, of course, Ricky Henderson, but another key for the A's has to be Canseco. In last year's World Series, in his second at-bat, it's a grand slam homer. It turns out that's the only hit he gets in the entire five games, and there it was. He was 1-for-19, and McGuire was 1-for-17.
And the way they pitched him is they crowded him, the right-handers, Hershiser with the fastball. Now, one thing I saw over the season, when Jose missed 88 games, when he came back, he could get
out in front on left-handers because the ball runs back over the plate, but the right-handers just bore the ball in on him, gave him a lot of problems.
The 1-2 pitch got him, breaking pitch, and down he goes. So Canseco becomes the first strikeout victim of the World Series. Two down and Dave Parker coming up.
And there's that expanding the strike zone like you talk about, Jim.
And what sets that up, Tim, I believe, is the fastball. Two pitches before, way inside, and you go away with a breaking ball.
Dave Parker, as loose as they get, three hits against Toronto in the playoffs, including two homers. So he made the maximum out of the minimum. The designated hitter stands in. And he'll be a very key man for the Giants to get all series long because the Giants have an all right-handed rotation. And he gets a comebacker knocked down by Garrelts, and Scotty throws him out. So each team gone in the first, no score in game one.
To you by the King of Beers. In the world of sporty imports, there was Toyota, then Honda. But today, there's something new, Geo Storm. It's going to hit with an aggressive stance, an eager multiport fuel-injected engine, and four-wheel independent suspension. Get to know the new Geo Storm. It's rolling in now. And it's just around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
You're looking at the reason McDonald's coffee tastes so fresh. It never gets a chance to sit around. McDonald's coffee tastes fresh because our coffee's always pouring.
Doctor, flying in a multiple trauma from Woodlake.
What are the injuries?
I need an EKG, current and basal.
It's been done at Woodlake.
I don't need them there. I need them here.
In the time it takes to transfer a patient, this doctor is able to prepare a treatment. Because now the network of U.S. Sprint can fax the sharpest graphics in the world in only 6 seconds.
Let's do it!
100% digital fiber optic fax. Only from U.S. Sprint.
It's 11:35, and Roseanne Horn is learning all about her antifreeze. The hard way. Don't push your luck. Guarantee it with Advanced Formula Prestone.
Come on, answer.
Well, are we all prepared for the baseball match today?
Mr. Belvedere.
Okay, troops, let's hit it.
In the front row, Saturdays.
Scott Garrelts, assuming the position of a catcher, blocks the ball and keeps it in front of him. The only problem was he doesn't have catcher's equipment on, and you could see Terry Kennedy saying, keep your chin up, Scotty.
So we go to the second inning in game one at Oakland. No score, Matt Williams to lead off, and then Ernest Riles and Candy Maldonado facing Dave Stewart. Williams started the season with the Giants, got off to an awful start, went to Phoenix, played very well for the Giants' AAA affiliate, and then he was called up for the second half of the season, and he has really filled the bill in the number five spot, and he's a great third baseman, and some people think he's an even better shortstop.
Shortstop in college at the University of Las Vegas in Nevada. Strong throwing arm. Good hands, soft hands for a big man. He's only 23 years old.
Well, if you watched him in the playoffs, he missed only one ball. Swings and misses here in the count 1-2. Roger Craig. Last time there was a Subway World Series in 1956, Craig was a Dodger. And as we mentioned at the top, a 15-cent Subway ride. Between the boroughs. 2-2. with probably the pivotal hit in the playoffs, that home run on the sensational at-bat in game four, the 12th pitch hit out to give the Giants a victory. Pop foul and back out of play. Still 2-2 on Williams.
A sequence of 12 pitches, and if you wanted to, if you went to anybody in the National League that's ever seen Matt Williams hit, you'd say throw him a lot of breaking balls if you can. First base open, Steve Wilson, who had a good year for the Cubs, a left hander on the mound. He threw him 11 fastballs, and the 12th pitch would happen to be a fastball. He jerked it down the line for a game-winning home run.
The 2-2 pitch is fouled away. Williams trying to work on two things. He has the power, that's obvious. He's got to lift the average because he hit only 202 during the regular season. And like most power hitters, try to cut down on the strikeouts. He fans 72 times in just half a season. And down he goes here. So Stewart has his first strikeout, one gone here in the second inning. And Ernest Riles is the batter.
Well, one of the philosophies of Dave Stewart is you got to establish the fastball, even to a fastball hitter,
right.
It's your best pitch. And what happens is the fork balls ahead of the count early on set up the fastball right by Williams. Boy, now you got him thinking the rest of the game.
Ernest Riles getting a chance to play because in the World Series now, the designated hitter used in the American League parks and the pitchers hit in the National League parks. And so Riles hits it foul. Ernest came over in a deal last year that sent Jeffrey Leonard to the Milwaukee Brewers. He can play third. He's a very versatile player and delivered a very key pinch hit down the stretch for the Giants, a grand slam home run one night in August in Philadelphia. That's grounded down to Phillips and an easy play for Tony. Two gone. Two out, bases empty in the second with no score. And Candy Maldonado is the batter. If the Giants have one problem in establishing the lineup this season, it's right field. They've used Pat Sheridan out there and Danelle Nixon and Candy Maldonado. And I think Maldonado's getting the start of the World Series because of two plate appearances in the playoffs, both resulting in walks. And one of them was a giant walk. No pun intended, because it was the first of three given up by the Cubs in that fateful eighth inning in game five. And then Will Clark delivered the single to center.
Maldonado, Butler, and Thompson walking in front of Clark's hit.
0-1
with two outs.
And Maldonado walking after fouling off several pitches.
That's the famous stare, the Dave Stewart, I guess you could call it stare, glare, whatever you want to call it. He glared after he made the error, and there's another glare.
Mm-hmm. Off the bay, beautiful shot, sunset in the Bay Area. San Francisco Bay in the background, and Maldonado has swung late twice at Stewart's fastballs, and the count is 1-2.
Dave Stewart, when he's had problems, they say they usually come early in the ball game, so you have to get him early. And he has a way of pitching to his competition. They get him a lot of runs. Sometimes he'll relax, give up some early runs, but I don't think he's going to relax against Garrelts.
2-2. Scott Garrelts viewing it from the Giants dugout. Back of first with two out, bases empty in the second inning. And Candy fouls it off. The bottom of the Giants' order is a key for the A's in the sense that they don't figure to do much damage, and the A's have to keep it that way. Maldonado, 217, Kennedy next, 239, and then Uribe in the ninth spot, 221. So the Giants normally do the damage at the top. 2-2. mentioned, released in 86 by Philadelphia. He said that wasn't the low point. He said the low point was 5 days later when nobody called. He said that was the lowest of the low. And then finally a call from Oakland. And here he is starting the World Series. 2-2. Tony La Russa, the A's manager for several seasons with the White Sox, let go there, immediately picked up by Oakland in 1986, and referred to by a lot of people now as the manager of the 90s.
The first thing he did in his first night, July 7th, we were doing the game in Boston, he let Dave Stewart start. He beat Roger Clemens.
That was 1986, yep. And Dave Stewart has not missed an assignment since then. Three straight years with 20 wins or more.
And down goes Maldonado. Stewart strikes out two in the second. No score in the middle of the second.
Something new is happening at Chevrolet. This year, we'll introduce more new ideas, innovative new engines, and bold new shapes than ever before. In 1990, you'll see why nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. All you have to do is...
the heartbeat of America. That's today's Chevrolet.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
This is the shop of Samsat Pazar, a thriving establishment on the outskirts of Bangkok. Unlike other international executives, he has no phone system, no computers, not even a fax machine. He does, however, enjoy one modern and efficient service nearly 4 billion people in 175 countries today can take for granted. UPS. We run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
If you thought you had to give up comfort to get a close shave, Norelco says, think again. Their revolutionary shaving system shaves skin close in a way that's incredibly comfortable. As the hair enters the chamber, the patented lift and cut system lifts each hair and holds it a split second before a blade cuts it, so it's possible to shave skin close without the blades even touching the skin. The lift and cut shaving system from Norelco. We made close comfortable.
I'm ready for one thing when I drive. Everything. Bad weather, bad drivers. I guess that's why we've got Michelins. Michelins are for all the things that can't possibly happen, but always do. Am I overprotective? I've got reason to be. The way I see it, you never need a Michelin until you really need a Michelin.
Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
If you have a heart attack, you may be a lot better off if you're in Europe than in America. An alarming new study. Watch Peter Jennings on ABC's World News Tonight, Monday.
What a difference a decade makes. In 1979, the A's barely drew 300,000 to the Coliseum. This year, 2.6 million. And next year, talking about 3 million. Dave Henderson, who always seems to wind up in the right spot to lead off, and then McGuire and Steinbach facing Scott Garrelts in the bottom of the second. Henderson, who was with Seattle in 86, winds up getting traded to Boston and helps them win the pennant. In 87, he winds up with the Giants, and even though he was ineligible for postseason play, he helps them to the division crown. He goes to Oakland, plays in the World Series last year, and here he is again. One account. Wendell Kim, the Giants first base coach, and there is Al Talboy. Talboy sitting in the stands. He's the eye in the sky positioning the Giants defensively. College coach on the peninsula, the San Francisco peninsula. There is where he's sitting. We talk about modern day communications. He calls down to Kim, and Kim aligns the outfielders.
Well, the reason he's sitting up that high, the worst place in the ballpark to view the defense is in the dugout. You're at field level, and you really can't, you have no depth perception.
As Henderson draws the walk, so Gabe gets aboard to start the second inning. Another reason, though, he's sitting in the stands is that he's the opposition. He's the visitor, and the A's wouldn't give him a credential for the press box.
Right. So he's above it.
Yep. Dave Henderson at first base, and Mark McGuire is the batter. Mark, a low average, but plenty of power, as has been the case since he came up with a bang in 1987.
0-1. A lot of people feel the reason, if you have a good fastball, you can throw it right by Mark McGuire. He has become a better breaking ball hitter. Garrelts throws well over 90 miles per hour. You saw the first pitch. It was a fastball. So we'll see how San Francisco does pitch to McGuire.
It's a high fly ball to center field. In his tracks is Butler. Tagging at first is Dave Henderson, but he's not going anywhere. McGuire gone for the first out in the bottom of the second inning. And that'll bring up Terry Steinbach.
Number 26, Terry Steinbach.
Steinbach, Tony La Russa feels, will be the premier catcher in the American League shortly. You'll recall last year, he made the All-Star team, and everybody said, who? What's the deal here? Part of it was ballot box stuffing by the Oakland fans. The other, the paucity of real quality catchers in the American League. And then, as you know, what happens is he winds up as the All-Star Game MVP with a home run in Cincinnati.
That's not your Spalding guide way to get back to first base. Henderson on his... Even David Clarker are laughing about it. Check this out.
Well, look at the lead. It's about, if he took a traditional one-and-a-half-step lead, he would have been in foul territory. He wasn't even off the bag.
A little bit better lead there.
Oh.
Dave, with 8 stolen bases during the regular season, he was caught 5 times.
That's why he's not taking a big lead.
That's right.
Garrelts comes to the plate, and it's lined in the center for a base hit. Henderson had to hold up to see if Thompson could catch the line drive, and so he stops at second. And the A's with 2 on and 1 out in the bottom of the second inning. Steinbach with Oakland's second hit, and Phillips is the batter.
The line of sight that Henderson has, you see, has to hold up because he can't tell how close that ball is to Robbie Thompson. And because he held up, that prevents him from going to third.
And also what the cardinal, one of the cardinal rules of base running, never get doubled up on the ball in front of you. Heads up base running.
Tony Phillips, the versatile infielder, can play second or third. He's a switch hitter, and it really doesn't matter. He's got a little more power this way. But he had 263 left-handed and 259 right-handed.
Also had a great September. Didn't hit that well in the playoffs. Made some outstanding defensive plays, but 29 for 84. That's 365 down the stretch.
And he grounds it to the right side, and Clark was going back to first base. It goes through the hole for a base hit. Henderson scores 1-0 with Steinbach going to third.
Being pulled on the pitch, a curveball, and then keeping your bat back and then committing with authority. And that's what Tony Phillips does. Rifles one in the hole, and not only does Henderson score, but Steinbach ends up at third base with one out.
And Walt Weiss is the batter. Infield at double play depth. La Russa not averse to squeezing in a situation like this.
Even though he only squeezed once during the playoffs and once during the regular season. Roger Craig, on the other hand, a guy who likes to squeeze more than Mr. Whipple.
Yep. And I say it only because of Weiss and the fact that Weiss has been bothered with a bad knee, so he's had an off year. And La Russa likes to be unpredictable.
also a perfect situation to start the runner. Kennedy doesn't throw that well. Weiss somewhat of a contact hitter. Trying to stay out of the double play.
One and one the count. Renee Laxman, after looking into the dugout, sending out the signs. One out with runners at first and third. And Garrelts fires over to drive Phillips back. One and one the count. Looped foul off to the left, and the count one ball and two strikes on Weiss, who, like Phillips, is a switch hitter. He hit 235 as a left-handed batter this year, 228 the other way. Outfield playing Weiss the other way, all the way around to left. They give him all of right field. And he slices it foul on the count one and two.
Sometimes a hitter can determine how a team's trying to pitch him by just looking at the outfielders. Now, there's no way Scott Garrelts is going to throw a breaking ball or a split-finger fastball here, the off-speed pitch, for a strike to Walt Weiss because of the positioning of the outfield. Hard stuff is more prone to be hit the other way. The soft stuff is more prone to be pulled.
1-2 pitch is hit slowly toward Clark. He's going to come home with it, and Kennedy drops it. 2-0. A, Clark appeared to have trouble getting the ball out of his glove, and then B, Kennedy can't hold on. And the A's have a 2-0 lead with two on and one out, and Ricky Henderson coming up.
The one thing you do when you're receiving a ball from the right side of the infield, if you're a catcher, is keep your weight on your left foot. Kennedy, with the weight on his right foot, allows Steinbeck to knock the foot away from the plate, thereby knocking the ball out of the glove. It should be an error on Terry Kennedy. That was a good throw by Clark. Terry had plenty of time. Good hard slide by Steinbach, but the reason that Steinbach was able to knock the ball out of Kennedy's glove was Terry had the weight on the right foot and not the left foot. If you have it on the left foot, you ward the base runner off the plate.
And Garrelts nearly throws one away, and the count is one ball and no strikes. They have given the error to Kennedy, an error on the catcher, so the bottom of the order accounts for two runs, still only one out, and Henderson, the leadoff hitter, takes a strike, and the count is one and one. Phillips at second, Weiss at first.
Even another situation where Henderson obviously would like to get a base hit, but if Scott Garrelts won't throw strikes, Ricky will go right down to first base, load up the bases, and let Carney Lansford, who had 336 and already has a base hit, hit. Very disciplined.
Good breaking pitch. 2-2.
Great breaking pitch.
Terrific.
2-1. Boy, right off the table.
Phillips to his lead at second. Weiss, the runner at first. Oakland leading 2-0, and the A's trying to break it open in the second inning. 2-2 to Henderson, just inside. Ball three, and Garrelts thought he had him. And now, 3-2 with one out.
You can judge for yourself. Boy, it looks like it has some of the plate. Scotty Garrelts certainly wanted, but again, Henderson jumping away from the pitch makes it a little bit more difficult for Rich Garcia, the home plate umpire.
See if La Russa starts the runners. He does not, and the pitch is hit into right field for a base hit. Phillips is being waved in. Here comes the throw from Maldonado. It's offline, 3-0. Weiss to third. impressive. Laxman never hesitated, sending the runner all the way, and Maldonado's throw was up the line.
Maldonado's throw should have been to third base. Excellent base running by Walt Weiss, who looked at Maldonado, and when Maldonado came home, Weiss goes to third to clear second for Ricky Henderson. Good piece of hitting, a poor play by Maldonado. That ball's got to go to third base.
Kelly Downs gets up in the San Francisco bullpen. The batter is Lansford, and he takes low ball one. Still only one out in the second inning. Three hits, a walk, and an error, and the A's are ahead 3-0. Lansford hit into 21 double plays this year. And it's low in the count 2-0.
Only struck out 25 times, Al, so a good contact hitter. They're not playing back for the double play.
And time called by Roger Craig. So a meeting at the mound, and Kelly Downs, who pitched very effectively in long relief, is up in the Giant bullpen, effectively in the playoffs. So in the inning, it begins, as so many of Oakland's big innings in the playoffs did, with a walk, this time to the other Henderson. Dave drew the walk, and after McGuire flies out, Steinbach with a single, Phillips with a base hit, then the error by Kennedy, the single by Ricky Henderson, and the count, two balls and no strikes on Lansford, with Weiss at third and Ricky at first. The shallow left field, Uribe goes out, Mitchell comes in, and Kevin makes the catch, and the runners have to hold. So a big out, the second out. The infield can move back, and Jose Canseco comes to the plate.
I think the reason Henderson didn't try to steal then, you've got Lansford, who had a base hit his first time up, a 336 hitter this year. And I don't know whether Ricky's going to run here either with Canseco batting.
Parker follows Canseco, who struck out in the first inning. Garrelts firing to first. The risk, of course, you run here when you throw the ball away on a pickoff play is with all the foul territory. The runner normally winds up at third. Pitch out, nothing happening. They thought Henderson was going. 1-0.
Well, you know, a lot of times if Henderson runs, obviously you have first base open. You may not pitch to Canseco, but down by three runs, you're thinking that way anyway. Garrelts is going to want to make the pitch to Canseco because he can't afford to give up any more runs. So if I was Tony La Russa, I think I'd send Henderson. Got Dave Parker on deck. If you walk Canseco, then obviously Parker, who led the A's in runs batted in this year with 97. They're strong throughout their lineup.
2-1. You saw that target. Canseco can hit it. You all recall the home run in Toronto that cleared customs.
As Bob Uecker said in the movie Major League, it was headed to South America. You needed a visa to get it.
2-1 to Canseco, a squibbed foul off the end of the bat, and the count, two balls and two strikes. Jose, the eighth man to come up in the second inning. Oakland with three in, and runners at first and third. Canseco, the broken wrist for half the season, then came back for the second half, and hit 17 home runs and drove in 57.
.871 steals, 67 behind Lou Brock. Lou with 938 stolen bases, the all-time stolen base leader, and Henderson could very easily break that next year. He's liable to end up with 1,500 stolen bases.
He says he's got five more years of 50-plus stolen bases.
He's had nine in a row.
And Will Clark has to come off the bag.
Well, Garrelts has got to be real careful, because if he balks, that's 4-0. And, you know, you have to make a step. And during the playoffs, as you look at the end of the throw, very close. Back too close.
I think he's out. Missed him. I think he missed him. If he hit him, he would have been out.
There goes Henderson, and it's popped up down the line. Clark giving Chase a lot of territory, and he can't cover it. So it's still two balls and two strikes.
Another look at that attempted pickoff. And Paul Runge at first right there, and he doesn't even move, so apparently he did miss him, Tim. I did about the health of Will Clark. Well, he was really limping going after that foul ball.
Soft throw to first, and of course Clark with that banged up knee, the result of a collision in September with Mike Socha of the Dodgers. It's the right knee. Much in evidence in the playoffs. And there as well. And the count now 3-2. So Henderson will be going. 3-2 and two out of the second inning. And Will Clark, knowing Ricky is going, can play off the bag and behind the runner at first base. 3-2 on Canseco. Jose swings and misses, and down he goes for the ace and eight men to the plate. Take a 3-0 lead, and back we come after a word from our ABC station.
Monday.
Are you ready, Buffalo football?
The undefeated Los Angeles Rams head east to tackle the Buffalo Bills on ABC's NFL Monday Night Football. Then, on Bangkok's black market, everything has a price.
You come looking for more trouble?
No, not really.
You're gonna die, pal.
MacGyver.
I'm telling you, she sold my house just like that. Dorothy Thompson, Century 21.
They listened to me, so they knew what I wanted.
Century 21?
Yeah, my broker sold my house, and I wasn't even in town.
The Century 21 system sells more homes than anybody else, because we have more experience than anybody else. But don't take our word for it. Ask a friend.
Come with us.
The house, the pool, is everything. I'm
going to
live here forever.
Century 21. Heineken, Amstel Light.
This is
so much better than other light beers.
It's a great imported beer.
A delicious European taste.
Nothing compares to the smoothness, the richness, or the character.
Distinctive flavor that cuts through your thirst.
Its quality comes through.
There's a uniqueness to it.
Heineken is America's number one selling imported beer. Amstel Light is America's number one selling imported light beer. Why? Just ask the people who drink them.
If you ask me, Amstel Light is the best beer there is. I could go on and
say enough about it.
It's a light beer.
No matter how many beers you're thirsty.
Hey, where's the food?
How about tacos?
Yeah, tacos!
Yeah, tacos!
Tacos! Tacos! Tacos! Tacos! Tacos!
Taco Bell introduces tacos to go. Now get our original tacos in a 10-pack for $5.89. Or a six-pack for just $3.54, packed and ready to go. Anywhere you've got a few hungry friends, tacos to go. At this price, it won't take much to keep them quiet.
When it comes to sports, your team is here on Channel 7.
In Oakland for game one of the World Series. A's draw first blood. 3-0. Goodyear blimp Columbia. Hovering above the San Francisco Bay Area. Low clouds. In the twilight. Temperature about 60 degrees. And the World Series. Game one goes to the third inning with Terry Kennedy to lead things off for the Giants. Kennedy, Uribe, and Butler. Kennedy came over in an offseason deal with Baltimore, Giants sending Bob Melvin to the Orioles. And when the season began, they figured he'd be the backup catcher to Kurt Manwaring. He's now number one, and he grounds one down to Weiss, who throws him out. out in the third inning, and Jose Uribe comes to the plate. And we can tell you that the only unbeaten team in the National Football League, the Los Angeles Rams, take their 5-0 mark into Rich Stadium in Buffalo to take on the Bills on Monday Night Football at 9 Eastern Time, 6 Pacific.
Frank Gifford and Dan Dierdorf will be Al Michaelis.
You might say. Not planning to be there on Monday night.
You have other things?
Yeah. Jose Uribe, switch hitter, takes a strike, and the count is 0-1. Giants shortstop as a left-handed batter, 276 this season, as a right-handed hitter, 200. And the pitch away, and the count 1-1.
Started the season hitting entirely right-handed. Went something like 4-for-50 and said, hey, that's not a good idea.
Yeah, he had bridled at that suggestion at the outset. And the count 1-2.
Tim McCarver told you about playing a guy one way and pitching him that way. And it appears they're playing him around the left field. They're going to throw him hard stuff. Maybe a fork ball when they get ahead in the count, like 1-2. But they're going to make him hit the ball to left field.
2-2.
The problem the Cubs had with Uribe in the playoffs, they threw him a lot of changeups. He doubled down the right field line when the defense was shifted the other way.
One out, base is empty, and the 2-2 pitch to Uribe hit right back to Stewart, who knocks it down, grabs it, then throws too late. So a break for the Giants as Stewart can't handle the chopper hit back toward the middle, and Uribe is on with one out.
Well, Dave, 0-for-2 tonight. Right there, I mean, he had plenty of time to field the ball. Probably had problems judging how hard it was hit. Again, takes his time. Uribe running hard all the way. Just beats it out. There's two outs that haven't been recorded for Dave Stewart and the Oakland A's.
Yeah, the only two base runners, an error on Dave Stewart, and a base hit by Jose Uribe.
It scored an infield single, and Brett Butler, they appeal at third base, and Dutch Reinert says, no, sir, 1-0.
Jim Palmer disagrees with the official score. I can see it in your eyes.
Right in the glove. I'm sure Uribe doesn't.
Swing by Butler, but he holds back in time. And then Brett goes after the next pitch and pops it up. It's an easy play for Walt Weiss on the edge of the grass. And Butler is out number two. So Uribe at first base, two down, and Robbie Thompson comes to the plate. It is difficult here at this time of day normally as you look at the outfielder's perspective, but as we mentioned with the low cloud cover, the outfielders and the hitters getting a break with the lights having almost full effect right now. Thompson takes a strike. No threat of rain. Funny thing about Oakland, though, I mean, this is normally the perfect month in the Bay Area, October, for the first ever World Series game played here in 1972 between the Reds and the A's, rained out on a night when the rest of the Bay Area was bathed in sunshine and a cloud literally hung over the Coliseum. 0-2. That's the night Bowie Kuhn went sloshing through the outfield, and when he came up with mud on his Gucci's, that was the end of that. No game tonight.
The pitch you see, probably the least likely pitch from Dave Stewart, the curveball or big swerve, fools Robbie Thompson. We told you, a high ball hitter, you better keep it down. You will have a good, healthy swing.
Runner goes, and Thompson has gone on strikes. And the Giants are gone in the third. Middle of the third, 3-0, Oakland.
Night, dear.
I think I left the living room light on.
I'll get it.
Oh, the kitchen, too.
Got it. Control your lights from anywhere in the house. Just buy $15 worth of Stanley Tools. And we'll send you a light maker, control unit, and lamp module free.
Did you leave the light on for Chris?
Of course I did.
Also, enter the Stanley Tools Secret to Security contest with 200 prizes, including 10 Chevy trucks at participating Stanley dealers.
Who's pulling away in advanced 4x4 technology, Chevy S10 Blazer or Ford Bronco 2? Both can get you through the mud. But when you shift from four-wheel drive high to two-wheel drive, Chevy with Instatrack never asks you to back up. While Ford says you should stop and back up 10 feet for reduced wear on their front drive system. Chevy S10 Blazer is number one, clean and simple. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Today's truck is Chevrolet.
You're in Hong Kong. I like it.
I like you loud and clear. I like you close and near. I like my MCI. I like to wander and roam. I like to call back home.
I get more.
More.
I like my MCI.
I like my MCI.
She's all ours.
Ladies' night.
Great place, guys. Who did your decorating?
Dave Parker to lead off in the bottom of the third inning. A's sending eight men to the plate in the second. They lead 3-0 in game one. Parker, Dave Henderson, and Mark McGuire facing Scott Garrelts. And the Cobra takes up high, ball one. Parker played in the World Series first in 1979, 10 years ago with Pittsburgh, and then last year hit 345 in the 79 series, and then last year 3-for-15 as the A's basically went into a collective slump against the Dodgers. And he gets a high drive to deep right field, and Dave Parker has hit his first World Series home run. Left-hand hitter, a low ball hitter, great hitting count, 2-0. He just dropped ahead of the bat.
Right.
And that ball was smoked. I mean, gone. That's grounded to Uribe. And Jose throws Henderson out. So one down in the third inning. Dave Parker hitting two in the series with Toronto, and really, of course, savoring the second one when he was able to take a peek at Kelly Gruber as he rounded third at the Sky Dome.
Here's the home run one more time. Watch the ball down and in. A 2-0 fastball, the most volatile area for a left-handed hitter in particular. That ball down and in. If it wasn't that volatile, when you think about it, they'd make tees higher.
Mm-hmm. Also, a very deliberate run around the bases, very much like we saw up in Toronto and here in Oakland during the playoffs. He was almost in their dugout. That's how wide a turn he took getting to first.
2-1 the count.
La Russa got him to shorten that little turn, though, last year. I mean, Dave would hit a home run and be in San Jose and then come back up the shoreline as it's grounded foul. And the count 2-2. With McGuire at the plate, we can take a look at where he normally hits the ball through the course of the regular season. As you can see, he's a pull hitter. Hitting predominantly to the left side. And the Giant defense reflects that. 3-2. In fact, in that low home shot, you see the center fielder, Brett Butler, playing in the pull. And when he hits the ball to the left side, 354, up the middle, 305, and no success at all when he goes the other way.
Yeah, hence the 231 batting average.
And he goes the other way, and it's a little looping fly ball to right field, but it falls in for a base hit. So McGuire, who hit 147 when he goes to right field during the regular season, hits a little looper for a single.
Of course, you don't want that to happen when you're already trailing 4-0, but over the course of a season, this is exactly what you want to happen to McGuire. Yeah, but it's mythical to think that you got to play all the power hitters deep in the opposite direction. Two guys in this game, Mark McGuire dumping one in front of Candy Maldonado, and Dave Parker doesn't have real good power the other way. He can't hit a line drive the other way over the opposite fielder's head.
Kelly Downs again up for Roger Craig in the bullpen with Stein back at the plate in the count 0-1.
Big difference between big strong guys like Parker and McGuire in the pull position as opposed to the opposite position. McGuire
Canseco,
to right.
Yeah, Canseco, you better play out on the warning track.
Yeah, because
right.
He's got good power the other way. McGuire has power with a fly ball, but if you play him shallow the other way, the fly ball itself, the loft of the fly ball, will allow the opposite fielder to get back under a ball like that.
1-2.
That gives you time. The opposite fielder, in my opinion, should position himself where the hitter cannot drive a ball over his head and thereby cut down on all the flares hit the other way, like the one McGuire just got.
And the perspective on where Maldonado was positioned was Stein back at the plate in the count 2-2.
Of course, if you go back to the reason why Maldonado is playing, Roger Craig will tell you it's a hunch, but I think Pat Sheridan, who played mostly right field, left-handed hitter, better defensive player. I think maybe Roger Craig thinks they need more offense.
Steinbach down on strikes. That's the second out with McGuire at first base. Two down in the third inning. Three strikeouts for Scott Garrelts. And it will bring up Phillips.
Tom Manning, second baseman Tony Phillips.
Tony Phillips singled in the second inning. One big difference between these two teams is that bottom of the order. We mentioned the Giants have a lot of trouble. 7, 8, and 9, of course. 9 being a situation where the Giants can have a regular as opposed to the National League Park as it's hit foul. And the A's are tough, though, at the bottom of the lineup with Steinbach, this man, Phillips, and then either Weiss or Gallego hitting ninth.
Of course, part of why a team is tough is that how do you pitch them? They're playing them the left field, and the first base hit was on a curveball. So really what Garrelts did is cross up his defense. You would assume they'd pitch Phillips away with hard stuff.
0-2 the count. McGuire, no threat to run at first base, so Clark is playing behind him. Balls and two strikes the count. And Phillips gone on strikes. But in the inning, the home run by Dave Parker. And at the end of 3, 4-0 Athletics.
Hello tomorrow, goodbye yesterday. You can feel the emotion, we're breaking away. Generation of life, we have our own voice. Generation of
Chevy S10 four-wheel drive pickups take on the four-wheel drive Ford Ranger. Look, to shift from four-wheel drive high to two-wheel drive, Ford says you should stop and back up 10 feet for reduced wear on the front drive system. While Chevy, with Instatrek, never asks you to back up, so you can go forward with Chevy or backward with Ford. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Today's truck is Chevrolet.
I thought I was hearing things. There's my IBM salesman telling me that we need a special piece of equipment that IBM doesn't even make, but offering to get it for me anyway, and to integrate it with what we already have. Ooh. So I asked him, hey, what's the story here? The story is that IBM is telling its people to solve problems, not just sell hardware and software. This is not the IBM I thought I knew.
The on-off endurance test. The shake test. The impact test. You'll probably buy only one furnace in your life, so buy the one that's built to last a lifetime.
The Lennox Pulse Gas Furnace. Take it from Dave Lennox.
For home heating, for cooking, hot water, or drying, choose gas, America's best energy value.
The 1989 World Series, brought to you by Today's Truck Chevrolet. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Fourth inning in Oakland, Al Michaels, Jim Palmer, Tim McCarver. Game one of the World Series, 4-0 A's, Will Clark to lead off. And this is exactly when the A's would love to see Will Clark all series long, leading off. Clark, Mitchell, and Williams facing Dave Stewart. And Will takes away ball two. 2-0. Giants limited to one hit. Scratch single in the third by Uribe. And Clark fouls it off, and the count is 2-1.
Al, we mentioned the controversy between Dave Parker and Kelly Gruber during the American League Championship Series. Because of the 4 days off that the Giants and A's have had, controversy has arisen from the Giants camp, too.
Foul away, and of course, Clark is in the middle of it. When you have 4 days off, it's almost like a Super Bowl. Week begins with Kevin Mitchell missing practice, and he was down in San Diego ostensibly closing on a house, even though there were some reports he was down there involved in a court case. As Clark pops it up in foul territory, and third baseman Carney Lansford is there to make the catch. One away with Kevin Mitchell coming up. Then, of course, it's Clark who on Wednesday begins to talk about his ex-teammate Jeffrey Leonard and describes him as a tumor. And then on Thursday, Leonard lashes back through the media by saying that Clark is a racist. Meanwhile, while that's going on the Giants side, on the A side, you have the never-ending Dennis Eckersley situation, which started during the playoffs with Cito Gaston in Toronto. And outside of that, nothing new this week. Mitchell at the plate, fouls it away, and the count is 0-1.
Bobby Brown, president of the American League, apparently is not going to look at the films that the Blue Jays sent to him until after the... And that, of course, is not from the Blue Jays themselves, but from the stadium operations up at the Sky Dome in Toronto. But he will wait till after the World Series.
Pitch Tony, away in the count 1-1.
Tony La Russa assured us that they can look all they want and they will find nothing.
And he was adamant about it.
You're better than your teammates, Kevin.
1-1 to Mitchell. Swung on and missed. And the count 1-2. One thing La Russa's concerned about with the Eckersley thing is Dennis is a very sensitive guy and very sensitive to these charges.
And he reacted. In fact, he was very apologetic that he apparently was profane in his reaction to Cito Gaston, that he lost his head, which is what Gaston wanted him to do. Hoped it would cause him to pitch less successfully.
In the dirt, 2 balls and 2 strikes on Kevin Mitchell.
A guy who is even more sensitive to his pitchers is the pitching coach of the Athletics, Dave Duncan. Tony says if you do something to one of the pitchers of the Athletics, Dave Duncan never forgets it.
Well, one of the things that happened, of course, you probably read about the Bobby Valentine controversy. Bobby was working the dugout area for NBC during the playoffs, and it was Duncan who thought perhaps that it was Valentine who tips Gaston off to Eckersley's supposed emery board. And Tony, even though he was implicated in originally, said, hey, look, I never for one moment doubted that Valentine was involved. I never said it. I don't know where it got started. And Valentine is not at all to be implicated. And, of course, Bobby, during the course of the week, said, hey, if anybody can prove that I had anything to do with that, I'll quit. I'll resign as the manager of the Rangers. 3-2 to Kevin Mitchell. He's lined into right field for a base hit. So the first solid hit for the Giants and their second hit overall. And Mitchell at first base with one out and Matt Williams coming to the plate.
You know, Kevin had such an outstanding National League Championship series. He hit 353 with two home runs, but overshadowed so much by Will Clark. He's been up twice. He's hit two balls right on the nose. One that was speared by Phillips in that line drive. But that's where you want him to hit it. Hit it the other way and hope it stays in the ballpark. They're hitting 47 during the regular season.
1-0 the count on Williams.
Again, remember what they say about Stewart. Has trouble usually early, but does pitch to the level of competition. He's got a four-run lead. He sat on the bench a long time.
Broken bat pop-up in foul territory, and lots of room in the logo for Connie Lansford. Two down. Logo of this particular World Series noted as the Battle of the Bay. And there is the Bay. San Francisco Bay. We're in what's known as the East Bay. And Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, if necessary, over in the city.
That looked like a silk screen piece of art, didn't it?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Dusk in Oakland.
Tell you to take you back to Steve Sachs's inside pitch about Dave Stewart. You saw Matt Williams, a good fastball hitter, getting jammed when he was ahead in the count on the fastball. And I think that herky-jerky movement of Stewart is one of the reasons for that.
Mitchell at first, and Riles takes up high.
That's another reason. Dave Stewart, of course, Al Michaels told you that he was released. But he has always had this kind of stuff. Was a closer down in Texas. Tried to mess around with a forkball. And Doug Rader, who did a great job with the Angels, said, hey, forget about that. You throw too hard. You're throwing that kind of pitch. And there's one in the dirt.
And blocked by Steinbach.
The minute the game comes over to Oakland, Tony La Russa says, hey, you're going to be a starter. You got a curveball. You got a fastball. But that forkball will make all those pitches better. Not when you throw it here, well out in front of home plate. Again, 21 wins last year, and 21-9 for Dave Stewart.
Two and two.
Last time a pitcher in the American League won 20 games 3 years in a row. When was that, Al?
Well,
you know the name?
Big right-hander from Baltimore.
Uh-huh. Actually, it was 4 years in a row, guys.
Underwear salesman?
Yeah. You're putting additional pressure on Stewart.
Oh, he's going to do it again. That's grounded toward the hole, and Weiss is there to plug it up and get him at second on the fourth. Giants done in the fourth. 4-0 open in the three and the hit.
It's not just a car, it's your freedom.
I don't care what they say. Parts aren't just parts.
Sure, there's other brands, but these GM Goodrich pads are full width.
And this is the built-in wear sensor that tells you when they need replacing.
The thing about a brake job is it doesn't take any longer to do it right.
A car that won't start, that's a problem. A car that won't stop.
See Mr. Goodwrench wherever you see these signs.
Brakes, most important thing we do on a car.
My Uncle Roy T. Cashin was killed when I was 11 years old. It had a lot to do with me wanting to become a volunteer fireman in the fire department.
We have a lot of trust in each other because our lives are in each other's hands.
Morning, Neil. How you doing?
I've been in a burning house, and it's a feeling I'll never forget.
Many of these firefighters trust Neil Cashin with their life insurance.
I think Neil got in the fire department because of the red lights and the sirens.
He's been with New York Life a long time, and with the fire department even longer.
If he's in the building with you, you don't have to worry about him leaving on you.
New York Life, the company you keep.
Union, yes.
Respect, pride. Our unions help make sure you take home more than just a paycheck. You take home your dignity.
America works best when we say union, yes.
Between innings, Dave Parker, they're giving a little advice to Canseco. Jose, you know, I know you're 1-for-21 in the last 2 years. Hit him that away.
Yeah, get the count to 2-0. Look for the fastball and drop the head on the bat. It's easy. Don't swing at those curveballs with two strikes and punch out twice.
Weiss leading off in the fourth inning. Weiss, and then the top of the order, Ricky Henderson and Carney Lansford. Four runs, six hits, and an error for the A's. No runs, two hits, and an error for the Giants. And of all people, Weiss drives one to right field and gone. Three during the regular season. Extra left-handed bat tonight, and it turns out to be the right choice. The A's have jumped on top 5-0. The Giant bullpen gets busy again, and Ricky Henderson is the batter, and Adley Hammaker gets up in the Giant pen. Two and oh the count.
See Weiss talking to hitting instructor Merv Redman, and Merv said he's been swinging so well right-handed that he's thinking about maybe exclusively hitting right-handed, and there he goes, hits a home run left-handed. Merv saying, hey, that's exactly what I told you to do.
All three of his homers this season came as a left-handed batter, and the count on Henderson is 3-1.
Come to think of Weiss's injury to his knee was his right knee, so it'd be less painful to hit left-handed.
3-2 the count. The quiet Giant bench with Craig and Dusty Baker and Bob Lillis. Brantley is also throwing, or Kelly Downs rather, is up again. It's the third time in the Giant bullpen with the left-hander Hammaker. And Henderson gone on strikes, one out.
I don't think there's any question that Ricky Henderson intimidates the umpires. I think he gets a lot of mileage out of questioning called strikes. He questioned that 3-2 pitch, and I think over the long haul, nobody in baseball gets as much mileage out of questioning umpires' calls as Ricky Henderson. As a matter of fact, he was even joined by George Steinbrenner when he was with the Yankees last year.
Lansford hits a fly ball to shallow left field. Mitchell comes in and puts it away. So two down after the leadoff home run by Weiss. And it'll bring up Canseco.
The strike zone controversy with Steinbrenner. Henderson was, will the strike zone be where he starts his stance, or will it be where he finishes? And the American League umpires said, hey, where you finish your stance is where we're going to call the strikes. Ricky didn't like it, nor did George.
Canseco now looks at a strike, and the count is 0-1.
We'll see if Dave Parker's advice helped. Jose been up twice, both times out on good curveballs, blown away on strikeouts.
1-1 the count. Well, one thing Roger Craig doesn't have to think about, since this is in the American League Park, is Garrelts and his removal for a pinch hitter at any particular point. The 1-1 pitch is hit foul, and that becomes an interesting little thing here, too, because then you say to yourself, how long do you leave Garrelts in? Because the Giants, with Robinson and the knee problem scheduled to work in Game 3, and they're thinking about maybe Lacoste or maybe coming back with Garrelts in the fourth game, that's something that has to come into play in Rogers' mind right now.
That's why this first game is much more important for the Giants to win than it is for the Athletics.
Another decision you have to make is Garrelts tired, pitching more innings than he ever has. Didn't pitch well in the playoffs. Struggled, obviously, here tonight. But do you let him really maybe destroy his confidence and get a little bit more tired?
Well, there's some question about how the Giants will set up the entire rotation for the series. There's little question in the A's camp. With Stewart tonight, Moore tomorrow, Welch in Game 3, and then Storm Davis in Game 4. And the count full on Canseco, 3-2.
Because if you ask me how come the transformation from Scott Garrelts from a reliever to a starter, Roger Craig will tell you he's got a fastball, he's got a curveball, and he's mixing them up well along with a forkball.
Up foul territory and room there for Clark, and Canseco is 0-3. He's done no damage, but that man has, among others. As we go to the fifth, it's 5-0 Oakland. Back we come after a word from our ABC stations.
Starting 2 weeks from tonight, four great stars in a series of all-new mysteries. Peter Falk, Burt Reynolds, Jacqueline Smith, and Telly Savalas. The premiere of the ABC Saturday Mystery in 2 weeks.
Over the past decade, all other lines of cars have led Mercedes-Benz in one crucial category. Depreciation. Which proves that sometimes great cars finish last. Mercedes-Benz, the resale legend.
Naturally, I like going out to eat as much as the next person. But frankly, there are financial considerations.
We knew that was going to be an issue, and we were ready. That's when we offered her a golden opportunity.
I was delighted to see McDonald's had actually considered my situation.
She was ecstatic. All she had to do was buy a medium or large order of fries, then peel the golden opportunity coupon.
Right off the box. It's good for 50 cents off McDonald's most popular sandwiches with a large or super-sized Coca-Cola on my next visit.
In this case, her golden opportunity was waiting at McDonald's.
In the glory days of Rome, Caesar entertained his guests with the most spectacular sporting events in all the empire. 2,000 years later, he still does. Caesar's Palace. Relive the legend.
This is Mark Coogan in the Eyewitness Newsroom. A Delta Airlines jet out of Los Angeles catches fire, but all are safe. And a Southland tour bus crashes in Las Vegas. Details right after the game.
Series analysis with Steve Garvey and Todd Donahoe after the game.
We go to the fifth inning, game one of the 1989 World Series. It's been that kind of night. That picture summing up Scott Garrelts' evening. Walt Weiss driving one over the wall. Dave Parker has also homered. The A's got three in the second, one in the third, one in the fourth, lead 5-0, and Dave Stewart sails along as we go to the fifth inning. Maldonado, Kennedy, and Uribe. Candy struck out in the second inning. Kennedy on deck. Funny thing about Kennedy, his father, Bob Kennedy, now a Giant consultant, was the first Oakland A's manager when they moved here from Kansas City in 68. As Maldonado pops it up in foul territory, and Mark McGuire has a lot of room. One gone. So now Kennedy, of course, grew up in a baseball family. His dad, the manager of the A's in 68, when Charlie Finley brought the team west, and now working in the Giant front office under Al Rosen. That's grounded to the right side. McGuire has no time to break back to first base, but Kennedy's a slow runner, and Stewart gets there to take the throw from Phillips. So two down in the fifth inning. Is that Roseanne? Is that the real Roseanne? That's the real Roseanne. Thought for a moment it was somebody dressing up as Roseanne. Nope.
You mean dressing down as Roseanne?
You said it. You said it.
Well, look, being very casual here. She'll be in mink over in San Francisco, no doubt.
Mm-hmm. Two down in the fifth inning, and Jose Uribe is the batter. Scratch single in the third was the first Giants hit. And count 1-0. One and one. Coliseum, this has been a real home of champions in the last couple of decades. Fifth time the World Series has been played here. And the former, and who knows, maybe future home of the Raiders. Grounded to short, Weiss on the run, throws him out, an easy inning. The Giants come quietly and quickly, and it remains 5-0 A's.
I was feeling pretty good when I saw my boy Joe in that new Oldsmobile. I thought Joe had finally matured some. But that new Cutlass Glade doesn't look like any Oldsmobile that I ever had. It's got something called a high-output Spark 4 engine. The next thing you know, Joe will be bringing home girls.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
Now get up to a $1,600 cash bonus on a 1990 Cutlass Calais. See your Olds dealer today.
I gotta meet her.
Down, boy.
Oh, it's now or never.
Attention, shoppers.
You're at a romantic dinner at her place. Candlelight, wine, something with a little spinach in it. And for dessert, humble pie. She sees your dandruff.
I don't have dandruff.
Fine. Use your regular shampoo.
I can't have dandruff.
Aisle 9.
You mean you use Head and Shoulders?
Yeah.
But you don't have dandruff.
Right. Neither will she.
Head and Shoulders.
Hi.
Because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
A6, hurry and you'll make it.
Delta Airlines ticket agent Sam Singletary knows how to get people moving.
Mr. Franklin, you're back.
But sometimes he has to show off a few moves of his own. The kind of moves that made him a first-string halfback. Sam Singletary shares a feeling with everyone at Delta. He loves what he's doing. And it shows.
We love to fly.
He's the kid.
And it shows.
My pain is at the bottom of my elbow. It's throbbing. The more you twist, the more the pain hurts. When I get a pain like that, I will take aspirin.
Today, Richard Mazzancini is trying extra-strength Tylenol gel caps. For pain like his, why take aspirin or ibuprofen when nothing works better than Tylenol gel caps?
The pain is gone. It's great. I feel good. No pain. It doesn't hurt. It feels fluid. I'm convinced I'm going to be a gel cap user.
Extra strength gel caps, only from Tylenol. For everyday pain, nothing works better.
Hi, my name's Dave Stewart of the Oakland A's. All my favorite shows are on ABC. MacGyver, 30-something, and China Beach.
Bottom of the fifth inning, Dave Parco will be leading things off for Oakland, as he did in the third inning with this result against Garrelts. He'll try to duplicate it against Atlee Hammaker, who comes in to pitch in the bottom of the fifth inning, and the count is 0-1. So we speculated before. I mean, Craig has to keep his options open, so he's elected to remove Garrelts, and Scott was, let's face it, ineffective, 5 runs in 4 innings, but it does give him that fourth game option now, and the count is 0-2. He's not locking himself into having to pitch somebody else in game four. He can now come back with Garrelts, who, when he's worked extensively on a given day or night, has not been effective on 3 days rest.
But he has been effective at Candlestick Park in San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, the whole Giants staff, I mean, their ERA of 2.72 at home, yet 3.92, almost 4 runs a game,
yeah,
on the road. So they, of course, these parks very similar in dimensions.
Wow, and also, you know, other than Dodger Stadium, Shea Stadium, right here at Oakland Alameda County Stadium in Candlestick Park, number 3 and 4 as far as the amount of runs scored per game, cutting down batting averages. Good places to pitch. Not tonight for Scott Garrelts, though. Down goes Parker, so Hammaker comes out of the bullpen to strike him out to lead off the bottom of the fifth inning, and Dave Henderson will be the batter. A's, as you can see, last year, Canseco hit that grand slam in game one, and then McGuire hit the game-winning homer in game three in the ninth inning, and that was that. And they've already hit 2 home runs and 21 at-bats in game one tonight. Dave Henderson, 0-for-1 plus a walk, takes low ball one.
Oh, yeah, it goes back to a point that you made, how important pitching going to be in this World Series. The Dodgers, best pitching in the National League, under 3 runs a game.
Grounded down to Uribe. And the low throw scooped by Clark. So 2 down. And the batter will be Mark McGuire. A reminder, next Sunday on ABC Sports, international basketball at its finest, McDonald's Basketball Open, featuring the Denver Nuggets of the NBA and teams from Italy, Yugoslavia, and Spain in round-robin competition. Live from Rome, next Sunday, 2:30 Eastern, 11:30 a.m. Pacific, here on ABC. McGuire takes outside, and the count 1-ball and no strikes. Mark with as many hits tonight as he had in the entire World Series last season.
1-for-17 last year. Canseco 1-for-19.
So a composite 2-for-36 as Clark, and even in Oakland, he can't make the play. Count is 1-1.
Did he lose that ball? He overran it.
Yeah.
I mean, he overran it. You know, maybe he thought he was feeling it in Candlestick Park.
Of course, you've seen him play in Candlestick, but also here, you really need to get a lot of help from not only the shortstop but the second baseman at first and third pop-ups because of a better angle. So Robbie Thompson, it's like playing in right here. If Robbie Thompson gives up on this ball, and you, right there, you see that Will Clark doesn't have any idea where it is.
Yeah. So I lost it,
get
too.
Some help. Yeah.
Yeah. Robbie had the best angle, but Will Clark had actually overrun it. But he fooled Thompson on the play. I think a play like that, with the conditions as ideal as they are right now, a case could be made that that should be an error.
Mm-hmm.
Will Clark, a usually outstanding fielder, and Robbie Thompson, you could see him pull up because he thought Clark was under the ball. He was under it, but not under it. He was under it, but he was 10 feet away from it. Three
Three balls, two strikes, two out, bases empty, 5-0 Athletics in the bottom of the fifth. And McGuire staying alive with a count 3-2.
Again, going back to that point about pitching, the point you made, Tim, is that you don't think the Giants have a Hershiser. Somebody that can dominate them like the Dodger pitching staff did last year and even dominated the National League this year. They just couldn't score runs.
Shattered bat and a looper into right center field and a base hit. So McGuire, who gets a second life when the foul ball drops untouched, capitalizes with a single to center. So Mark is 2-for-3 tonight, and the A's have had at least one man on in every inning.
Again, the hard stuff. If you're not trailing 5-0, this is what you want McGuire to do. Hit 33 home runs this year, along with Jose Canseco, the only guys in baseball history that have ever hit 30-plus home runs their first 3 years. So you'll take the looper.
Smaller guys can't get hits like that. Number one, they're not strong enough to carry it over the infield. And number two, the outfield is more shallow for the smaller guys, and they catch a ball like that. So there's a lot more of an advantage to being big and strong. Number one, they play you deeply to where you can get your share of broken bad hits. And that's what Mark just did.
So McGuire tonight with a little looping fly ball that drops into right field for a single and a shattered bat single, and Steinbach fouls it away. And the count is 1-1. Crowd getting on Clark as Will this time does run out of room. What can you say about Will Clark after that National League Championship Series? They should name a candy bar after him, right? You've got a Reggie bar.
Already have.
Baby Ruth, that's what I'm saying. The name is already taken.
He did so well against the Cubs, they named a street after him in Chicago.
Right, on the corner of Addison and Clark.
Yeah, Mitchell might change his name to Addison, right?
That's grounded foul, and the count is 1-2.
The thrill bar. Apparently, Ken Griffey Jr., they sent a box of Ken Griffey Jr. of candy bars. They said, couldn't you come up with a more original name for the bar?
I don't know if a thrill bar would sell.
Not in Oakland, it would.
I'd have second thoughts about buying a thrill bar.
You would?
Yeah, I would.
You'd have bought one in San Francisco Monday afternoon. You'd have bought anything. 2-2. McGuire at first base, and Clark playing behind him with two out in the fifth inning. A's on top, 5-0. In the air to left field, and Kevin Mitchell positions himself to make the catch and retire the side. Oakland gone in the fifth, it remains 5-0.
I was always the quarterback's favorite target. I never dropped the ball because I had hands like glue. And even after football, I stick with my favorite beer, Miller Lite. I don't want some watered-down version of a regular beer. I want the less filling beer that tastes great.
Why? Not again.
Thanks, Andy.
Thank you, Dwight.
Nice. There's no catch when it's Miller Lite. Less filling tastes great.
Trofeo, Trofeo.
It's a new generation and we want a new horse.
Sequential port, fuel injection, anti-lock brakes.
It is come and we want a new horse.
Visual information center, handles great.
This Oldsmobile is not our father's.
New generation for the sons and daughters.
Trofeo.
This is the new generation of Oldsmobile.
Every one of these police cars comes on Goodyear Eagles, and only on Goodyear Eagles. Why? Because they want it that way. Goodyear Eagles, there really is a difference.
You've been staring out there all day. What are you doing?
Trying to figure out
Which computer is the most powerful?
Well, that's easy. The one with the most memory. Megahertz, MIPS, you know.
No, I don't think so.
There we go.
I think the most powerful computer is the one that people actually use.
Macintosh has the power to change the way you look at computers.
But that's not really a fair comparison. People like using the Mac.
The 1989 World Series, brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future, now at your Oldsmobile dealer.
Well, we describe this more as a love fest than a rivalry. Don't you guys get the feeling that it's summed up, the Bay Area feeling is really summed up by those fans who wear those hybrid caps, half Giants, half A's?
Yeah, right. Well, dinner last night, somebody said, have a good game. And I said, well, and who should I root for? And from both sides of the table, I heard A's and Giants. So, I mean, a lot of people probably haven't made up their mind at this point.
You kind of get the feeling it's an inner squad game, right? A spring training game or something.
At least at the outset. But let's see how things go along about next Wednesday. Uh-huh.
Over the winter.
Yep. The lines could eventually be drawn. Game one. Moving to the sixth inning, Dave Stewart on the mound. And he's been ahead on the count to just about all of the Giants because he picked up that early lead. He's limited them to two hits. And it's the top of the order, Brett Butler at the plate. Taking high, and the count two balls and no strikes. Butler, Thompson, and Clark. Every time Butler comes to the plate, you'll see that shot of Lansford or any third baseman in on the grass because of his bunting prowess in there, and the count 2-1.
Again, Butler really hitting Stewart well in the American League when he was over there with Cleveland, 11 for 28 with 10 walks, so on base about 55% of the time. And that's what he's got to do. I mean, if you want to contrast Brett Butler in the playoffs to Ricky Henderson, didn't take as many pitches as Henderson did. Didn't walk as many times. Did not have a particularly good series, only hitting 211. There he takes it. He's going to make Stewart work down by five runs. And if he gets on, boy, then you got a pitch to Thompson and Clark and Mitchell and Williams.
3-2 to Butler. He's popped in the air in foul territory. Lansford and Steinbach both come over, and Carney puts it away. One down in the sixth inning. Again, the Giants with just two hits. The scratch single by Uribe, which could have been scored either way. And the single the opposite way by Mitchell in the fourth. Stewart has not walked the man. And he has struck out three. Robbie Thompson at the plate. 1-0.
Perfect example of how good stuff Stewart has. He got behind Clark 2-0 last time, threw him three straight fastballs and got him out. You just don't see that. 2-0 in the playoffs. That's how Clark hit 13 for 20.
Little pop up on the skin part, Phillips. Two down. And it will bring up Clark. We last saw that in Chicago before the playoffs, an aerial shot of the Cubs logo here, one of the skyscrapers with Go A's in lights on the shores of Lake Merritt. Goodyear Blimp, Columbia providing the shots. Oakland sparkling on this Saturday night, the opening night of the World Series. Clark at the plate in the count 1-0. Seiko goes back and misjudges it over his head and bounding away. And Clark goes into second with a double. So Canseco having trouble gauging it. Clark hitting it sharply and the Giants with their third hit.
For the second time, and just about every outfielder will tell you, the hardest play is the ball directly over your head. You don't really know which way to turn. And he turns to his left, and again, the ball hit awfully well. Slight misjudgment, but that's two line drives that Clark's hit tonight.
The batter is Kevin Mitchell. It's in the dirt. Clark has to hold it second. To show you Stewart's dominance to this point, that's only the fourth ball the Giants have hit out of the infield. Two of them by Clark. One a fly ball to center. Now the double. Butler fly to center to start the game. And then Mitchell with a single to right. Two and oh.
And Stewart, if there's any weakness, does give up a lot of home runs, 23 over the year in 257 innings, but no three-run home runs, no grand slams. And also enough arrogance that even when you're facing a guy that hit 47 home runs and two in the playoffs, you'll come with a five-run lead right down the middle and say, hey, is my stuff better than yours?
Mitchell just missed that 2-0 fastball. Could have been a 5-2 ball game very easily. People talk about baseball being a game of inches. In no other area is it more evident than on the bat. Difference between a swing like that and a ball going out of the ballpark about a half an inch. Get under the ball.
2-2.
Of course, Dave Stewart, what he's hoping, that the reason he's won 20 games over the last 3 years is that he has just enough movement, Tim.
Yeah.
To cause that half an inch or quarter of an inch, the difference between a line drive and a pop-up, home run, and maybe a base hit. He is not afraid to throw the ball over the plate.
Four for Dave Stewart. Giants waste a double by Clark. It remains 5-0 A's.
It has arrived.
Good morning, Mr. Graves. This is the all-new four-door Cutlass Supreme. Your mission is to show the world that is causing an automotive revolution. Its sleek look and responsive performance make it a superpower among world-class cars.
This is not your father's automobile.
Ready, head up!
This is the new generation of
us. It's all right, I've got my card. I like it.
I like to wander and roam. I like to call back home. I like my MCI. I like you loud and clear. I like you close and near.
I get more.
More.
I like my MCI.
I like my MCI.
I just did something incredible. 5 minutes ago, I had gray hair, but now I don't. And this is what did it. New Option Instant from Clairol. The advanced way to get rid of the gray. New Option Instant for men is different. There's no messy mixing. It's so easy. Just press, apply, and only 5 minutes later, your natural-looking color's back. Hair even feels thicker. So why look like this?
When you can look like this.
New Option Instant from Clairol. The advanced way to get rid of the gray.
Well, fans, it all comes down to this moment. This is where it all gets decided. Johnson steps in, checks the signs, makes a few adjustments. This is a classic confrontation. He's digging in. Here's the delivery. And there it goes. He's going back, back, way back. It is going, going. It is gone.
Pepsi, a generation ahead.
Thursdays. The Young Riders.
Game one of the World Series at the Oakland-Alameda County Coliseum. And the A's are ahead 5-0 as we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. Tony Phillips, Walt Weiss, and Ricky Henderson. Phillips, switch hitter, comes up right-handed for the first time in the game. And the pitch is high for a ball. Joseph playing a pretty pat hand for the most part. Really, the only decisions he has to make is in regard to his middle infielders. He also has Mike Gallego, and you've got any combination of Phillips and Weiss and Gallego. And then behind the plate with Steinbach and Hassie as Phillips singles to right field to start the sixth inning.
Well, he said he'd like to get Gallego in tomorrow night, but the way Weiss and Phillips are swinging the bat, Tony being a switch hitter, as you saw him get a base hit earlier, left-handed, now right-handed. I'll tell you one thing, you talk about great pitching. One of the reasons are guys like Phillips, former shortstop, now plays second base, great range, good arm. It's a lot easier when you're out on the hill.
Walt Weiss, his home run in the fourth inning, made it 5-0. Turning around right-handed. He had 228 as a right-handed batter during the regular season. And squaring the bunt takes outside, ball one. Rene Latchman, who, by the way, is very much in contention for the managerial job at Cleveland, which is open, and the Indians giving every indication of talking to Latchman at the end of the World Series. Was flashing the signs from third. Latchman, of course, has prior experience as the manager of the Milwaukee Brewers at one time and the Seattle Mariners as well. Missing a bunt attempt in the count 1-1.
There's a situation, Tim, where if Weiss bunts Phillips over, Henderson on deck, do you walk him? I mean, you really take the bat out of Ricky Henderson.
Not when you're behind by five runs. I don't intentionally walk anybody, I don't think.
So you let Henderson hit off of Hammer.
Yep.
Okay.
Swings away and rips it foul. Does Weiss in the count 1-2.
Hey, you talked about Rene Latchman and Dave McKay at first base. This ball foul by about a foot or more.
How much more?
How the eyes deceive you.
To the count on Weiss. Williams has backed up at third, and Hamaker with a token throw over to first.
Okay, I'm hanging on Rene Latchman.
Rene Latchman and Dave McKay over at first base. Dave McKay, also the physical fitness coach. And the Oakland A is really a top shelf organization to the extent that their coaches get extra money for the success of the ball club. We'll tell you about it after this pitch.
Called strike three. So Weiss has a word with the plate umpire, Rich Garcia, and down he goes. He's Hamaker's second strikeout victim.
Peter Gammons of Sports Illustrated and a super writer told me before the game that the Oakland A's coaches, if the Athletics win the division, they get $10,000 extra. If they win the pennant, they get $10,000 extra. If they win the World Series, they get $25,000 extra, which means $45,000 into the pockets of coaches who don't make a lot of money, and that's on top of their World Series share.
And last year was over $100,000.
Yeah.
Where the winners and the losers make almost as much. There's not that much of a disparity.
You know, you rarely see incentives for coaches, but those guys do a great job. Most of them are not paid a lot of money. And I think it's terrific of the A's to have that system working, because nobody puts in more work than major league coaches. Tony La Russa handles the people. He handles the players. But all the work's done by the coaches, all the physical work.
Another benefit, of course, coaching with a club like Oakland and having back-to-back years is that you are considered for the managing openings, as Latchman is. And, of course, even though Dave Duncan is not linked to any particular opening or to any particular situation, the day will probably come when Dave will be more than seriously considered. That's headed to right field for a base hit. Phillips takes the big turn at second. The throw comes in, and then he gets back. He rounded the bag, looked at Laxman, and then scrambles back ahead of the throw for Maldonado. So Henderson with a single to right, and Ricky is 2 for 4. And the A's now have 10 hits in the game.
And the reason that Phillips Omley on an excellent execution of hitting, Maldonado playing very much shallower than he did before the off field on a right-hand hitter that does not have a lot of power. See Phillips just barely getting back as Uribe tries to make the tag. Good throw by Maldonado. We saw a bad throw earlier as he hits the cutoff man almost comes into play as an out.
Carney Lansford, a single and 3 trips tonight. Infield at double play depth, and the pitch is taken for a strike, and the count is 0-1. Jeff Brantley starts the throw in the San Francisco bullpen. Phillips at second and Ricky Henderson at first. And Hamaker misses away in the count 1-1. Brantley in the Giants pen. Giants going with a 9-man pitching staff in postseason, and the A's with 10.
Roger Craig very, very impressed with Jeff Brantley, thinking Jeff could be a terrific stopper someday. Right now he's middle relief. A lot of young pitchers come up in that particular style. They're middle relief until they get over the early jitters, and then they're either moved into a starting position or an effective short man, depending on their effectiveness, of course.
7 wins, 1 loss over the season. Likes to bring him in to get out of an inning because he apparently has nerves of steel. Doesn't seem to bother the base-loaded situation.
A little chopper foul for the moment. He's a setup man. The Giants closers, of course, are Steve Bedrosian from the right side and Craig Lefferts from the left side. Brantley and Downs and Hamaker, the middlemen. But going back to what we said at the very beginning tonight, I think it can only be appreciated in retrospect what Roger Craig has done this year with the Giants, with the pitching staff, with the injuries, to use 15 different starting pitchers, to have guys off and on the disabled list all season, and never lose more than 3 games in a row.
Of course, a lot of people feel that maybe the split finger fastball had hurt, caused some of the shoulder injuries. Roger Craig says, ask any of the pitchers. They don't seem to think that'd be the reason. Maybe it's the cold weather in Candlestick Park. You know, they pitched extremely well there. A lot of people think a split finger fastball is a very unorthodox pitch. Successful, but you don't have your fingers behind the ball. You have them around it. It's contrary to a lot of pitching.
Lansford hits a fly ball to right field. Maldonado started in, now backs up a few strides. Phillips tags but holds at second as the throw comes in. And that's the second out. So 2 down in the 6th inning with the A's ahead 5-0. And Jose Canseco is the batter. He's been silent tonight. He has struck out twice and fouled a first.
Dangerous situation, however, for Hamaker because he throws in that zone that Jose likes it. A better low ball hitter, Hamaker, to be effective, has to keep the ball down. Jose, with that heralded 900 number, he's now 1-for-22 in the last 2 World Series. He might have to change it to 9-11. 9-1-1.
Either that or you should call collect.
Everybody who calls is calling collect.
Roger Craig now will go to the mound, and with Canseco, the right-handed batter, up here. Brantley in the bullpen.
What I meant by that is they call and he collects.
Yep. So as Craig goes to the mound, he's going to the bullpen as well. Brantley comes in to face Canseco with 2 on, 2 out, 5-0 the score, and we'll be back after a word from our ABC stations.
Next Saturday, who's the biggest of them all?
Who's your little friend?
Wow, you're almost as big as my mom.
Mr. Belvedere. Then.
I've never gotten a C in my life.
Neither have I, no matter how hard I try.
Living Dolls.
This is the shop of Samsat Bazaar, a thriving establishment on the outskirts of Bangkok. Unlike other international executives, he has no phone system, no computers, not even a fax machine. He does, however, enjoy one modern and efficient service nearly 4 billion people in 175 countries today can take for granted. UPS. We run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
Introducing the Hyundai Sonata.
Uh-oh. Traffic.
It has a more powerful standard engine than a Honda Accord. Or a Toyota Camry. Plus, more interior room. Yet it costs thousands less. In 1988, 4 million Americans bought mid-sized cars. Maybe they should have waited a year.
Did you say something about traffic?
The new mid-sized Sonata from Hyundai. We're making more sense than ever.
I've got a craving that it'd be so nice to get a piece of pizza, a hot and juicy slice. I got those gotta have a pizza blues.
Looking for a slice at a great price? Get new piece of pizza at AM PM Mini Markets. Pepperoni or Supreme Combo, just 89 cents.
Come on, baby, to the right address. Fill up at AM PM and you'll fill up for less.
This is Mark Coogan in the Eyewitness Newsroom. The price of parking goes up on Southland streets, and rain causes traffic problems in the San Gabriel Valley. We'll have details right after the game.
Series analysis with Steve Garvey and Todd Donahoe after the game.
Dave Stewart looking on with a five-run lead, and the A's trying to make it more with Canseco at the plate, Brantley into work, and the first pitch away in the count, one ball and no strikes. Brantley, a teammate at Mississippi State of Will Clark, and coming in here trying to keep the Giants remotely in the game. Canseco hitting with two out and two on, and the A's ahead 5-0 in the sixth inning. And he's behind 3-0, and on deck, of course, is the left-hand batting, Parker.
And I would think Canseco would be hitting here 3-0. Tony La Russa knows that with one swing, Canseco could put this game out of reach. Parker helped do this home run back in the third.
And Brantley walks him on four, so the bases are loaded. Two down. Dave Parker hit back to the box, homered, and struck out. Mike Lacoste going down to the Giants bullpen. Parker nubs one foul off to the left. 0-1 the count.
Very early on, even though Parker with a home run, you get an idea of who the Giants want to pitch to. Will it be Canseco or will it be Parker? You know, Parker had a splendid year. 22 home runs, led the A's in RBIs.
The 0-1 is in there. The count 0-2. Parker, you might say, hopping mad over the goal.
Also at 38 in his last year, as you watch. Yeah, a little bit low, Richie Garcia.
The 0-2 pitch. Just low, one ball, two strikes. Dave, with that earring, he went to a bigger model for postseason play. More like a half-carat job during the regular year. Now we're talking Tiffany's. And he It's a ground ball to the right side. Thompson gobbles it up, then the force to Uribe at second. So Brantley gets out of it. A's lead three, but lead 5-0. On to the seventh.
6 years ago, a new car maker called Lexus began a relentless pursuit.
Basic need to seek out for ourselves a quiet place. Oshkosh now makes clothing for that search. Clothing that brings together the soul of both nature and man. Rugged, comfortable, enduring. Celebrate your natural instincts in Oshkosh Sportswear. Now available at Sears.
Put it in there.
Nolan, are you still throwing outside?
She's right. Try low and inside.
For everyone who has ever dreamed.
And felt like a lightning rod.
Are you feeling okay?
Yes, yes.
Life goes on tomorrow.
Rebecca!
Following the World Series.
Teams develop distinctive personalities and styles. The combative A's of the 70s, the We Are Family Pirates of 1979. What about the Oakland A's? I asked Tony La Russa to describe this group.
Al, I really think that the character of our club is a very close one. This club is very, very tight. These guys have a lot of respect for each other. And I really think that's where it started last year. These guys first all respected themselves professionally. And I know that there isn't one time where there's even a hint of not backing each other up, not supporting each other. So I think the closeness on the club is what marks this team. I think the talent everybody looks at, I think they're very professional, but they're very close.
And they're on top 5-0 as we drive the seventh inning. Matt Williams at the plate, and the count 2-0. Williams, Riles, and Maldonado. The A's have had things their way from almost the outset. 3 in the second, 1 in the third, 1 in the fourth. La Russa, I think many of you know, has a law degree. When Tony left baseball in the late 70s, he picked up his law degree at Florida State. And it was a funny thing. While he was there, the late Dick Houser was the baseball coach for the Seminoles. And he said he picked up a lot from Dick and also Bobby Bowden, then and now the football coach, and Hugh Durham, the basketball coach as well. As Williams, it's a fly ball to left field. And Ricky Henderson is right there for the out. One away.
How about that graphic? The longest continuous A's manager since Connie Mack. Retired back in 1950.
And Mack owned the team, so that's why he was there over 50 years.
And he managed in a suit. Not a baseball suit either.
Is there a connection there? He managed in a suit, and La Russa has a law degree. Hmm.
There is a connection, yes.
Yeah, but we'll drop it. It's the 0-1 pitch. It's a spurious one. 1-1. Riles, the Giants DH. Grounds one to the right side, and McGuire shovels to Stewart. Two down in the seventh inning, and it will bring up Candy Maldonado.
By the way, other lawyers who were managers in the major leagues, Branch Rickey, Monty Ward, Huey Jennings, and Miller Huggins. And those four are in the Hall of Fame.
And there have been a few clubhouse lawyers.
Oh, indeed.
By the way, the Athletics, the last time they were involved, or they had a World Series shutout thrown by an A, 1931, when the team was in Philadelphia. George Earnshaw did it. The only reason we bring it up is because you think of the great A's teams in the early 70s with Hunter and Lou and Holtzman, Odom, and you would have thought somebody along the way would have thrown one, but uh-uh. That's ripped foul, and the count, no balls and two strikes.
When you look at the scores of the 72, 3, and 4 World Champion A's when they beat Cincinnati, the New York Mets, and the Los Angeles Dodgers, all low-scoring ball games. Even last year in losing to the Dodgers, they had low-scoring ball games. The only game they won, 2-1, when McGuire hit the home run.
Game three, Steinbach comes all the way back and has room to make the catch on Maldonado's little pop. And again, the Giants are gone in order. It remains 5-0, Oakland.
IBM presents You Make the Call. With a runner on second, a batter hits a ground ball towards third. The fielder dives in vain, but then the ball hits the runner. Is he out? You make the call.
You got to juggle 10 things all at once. And get them done right. Get them done before lunch.
How are you gonna do it?
Well, you're gonna PS to it. With the IBM PS2. You can do things with microchannel that other computers just can't handle. You got an edge in power and speed. You're a forward thinker. Yes, indeed.
How are you gonna do it?
Easy. You're gonna PS to it.
The solution is IBM.
Because the fielder had a clear chance to catch the ball before it hit the base runner, the runner is safe and the ball is still in play. If you said so, you made the right call.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Cold filtered, never heat pasteurized. Miller Genuine Draft. For those who've discovered his real draft taste, the world is a very cool place.
Want to know how fresh McDonald's Grade A eggs are? Every day our hens are called on to lay 2.5 million of them. McDonald's breakfast tastes fresh because our eggs don't lay around.
When lunch and a day at the park are too much for Tommy Lasorda, he reaches for Rolaids. Nothing works better for acid indigestion. And why should heartburn take the fun out of the game? Relief. You know how to spell it.
The 1989 World Series. Brought to you by Lexus Automobiles. The result of a relentless pursuit of perfection.
Heading to the bottom of the seventh, Al Michaels, Jim Palmer, and Tim McCarver in Oakland, where the A's lead game one, 5-0. And Dave Henderson to lead things off against Brantley in the bottom of the seventh by grounding one on one hop to Williams. And that's throw to Clark for out number one. So Henderson has been silent tonight. So has Canseco. But Parker and Weiss have hit homers. The A's with three runs in the second. And Stewart's been masterful. And they lead 5-0 with Mark McGuire coming to the plate. Goodyear Blimp, Columbia. Tom Mattis is at the controls tonight. Cruising high above Oakland. Ship will head about 8 miles west on Tuesday for game three. How far is it between the Coliseum and Candlestick Park? Well, with zero traffic, it's about a half-hour drive. With an overturned big rig, pack a lunch. 1-1. as the blimp flies. It's about 8 miles. There it is, San Fransicso and Candlesticks in the extreme southeastern corner, and Oakland. And at some point, weather permitting during the series, we'll try to give you some perspective from the blimp, two stadiums. McGuire wraps one into left field for a base hit. So Mark, who was 1-for-17 in last year's World Series, is 3-for-4 in game one tonight.
The first thing he'll tell you, he loves being the one that does not be the focus of attention. Anonymity. When he hit 49 home runs 3 years ago, everybody wanted to interview him. He went right out through the writers, and there's a mass here right to the batting cage. Nobody asked him anything. I want to talk to Canseco, to Ricky Henderson, Tony La Russa. And that's exactly the way La Russa, excuse me, not Russo.
Poor Tony, at least people have finally begun to pronounce his name correctly most of the time. I mean, for years, they used to call him Rudy La Russa after the Laker forward who played opposite Elgin Baylor. And occasionally, he still referred to that on a newscast or sportscast or two. But he's very much establishing his own identity. Back-to-back to the World Series, and among the other treats he'll have next year is, you know, he's going to manage in the All-Star game. Little pop-up in foul territory. Clark gimping back and makes the catch like a highlight player. And also paying a little bit of a price. And you can tell that knee is really bothering him. Using that glove like a cesta here.
Full extension. And watch after he makes the catch how he comes to a limping halt. Takes you back to that triple he hit against the Cubs. And eventually scored the first run in game five. And then won it with the eighth inning single. Good play by Clark.
Phillips at the plate. 2-for-3. That's the seventh foul out in the game. And it tells you something about this ballpark. 1-0 with more foul territory than any park in the majors, it would figure. Circular stadium, built for both baseball and football, and as we mentioned before, the longtime home of the then Oakland Raiders, and the city of Oakland trying to get the Raiders back.
Along with the city of Sacramento. Mm-hmm.
And a few others. 2-0. But it's funny the way things have transpired in this city. The Raiders were here, sellout after sellout, and out they went. And we talked about it at the beginning tonight. The A's came west in 68 as you look at the panoramic shot of Oakland. And this franchise hit bottom in the late 70s. And it was saved by the Haas family, a San Francisco family, a Levi Strauss Company family, Walter Haas Sr. and Jr., and their son-in-law, Roy Eisenhart, in a press conference in 1980 to the surprise of everyone, bought the team from Charlie Finley and reestablished the franchise's roots. That's fouled away in the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Early 80s, Billy Bork, ball with Billy Martin. Ricky Henderson stealing 130 bases. 1981.
They inherited Billy Ball. Billy was here, so he came with the company. And then, of course, in 81, they won a division title. And that was the year of the strike. They beat Kansas City in those mini playoffs. And then on to the ALCS, where they lost to the Yankees.
Lost to the Yankees 3 straight. And how did the Yankees celebrate it? A fight between Greg Nettles and Reggie Jackson.
In the old Oakland tradition.
Yeah, right.
2-2.
Yeah.
I would say not only were the A's of the 70s a dynasty, certainly, by today's standards, 5 first-place finishes in a row, 3 world titles, probably the most colorful group in recent times as well.
Yeah, they proved you don't have to get along to win.
Mm-hmm. 3-2 the count. And yet through it all, they played in relative anonymity. For a team that won 3 straight world championships, attendance was simply average.
A tough time drawing 1 million people in those days. 1 million a year.
3-2 the count, 2 down. McGuire off and moving from first base. And the pitch is lifted to center field. And Brett Butler is there to make the catch. And down go the A's in the 7th. The Giants come up in the 8th, trailing Oakland 5-0.
People are moving to Diet Pepsi, the right one.
At Lexus, we didn't just suppress the engine noise. We suppressed the gear noise. The exhaust noise. The wind noise. And all that was left was the perfect environment for you to create a little noise of your own. The new Lexus LS400 luxury sedan. Lexus, the result of our relentless pursuit of perfection.
Mr. Ian McKenzie.
I'm Angus McKenzie. Yanks moved down the road.
Today, with service to 175 countries.
Oh, you've been wanting Ian Alistair McKenzie.
UPS delivers to nearly 4 billion people.
Parcel for McKenzie.
Aye.
Including the extraordinary concentration of McKenzies along the northeast coast of Scotland.
Mr. Ian Alistair McKenzie.
No trouble finding me, did you, lad?
No trouble at all.
UPS. We run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
I wanted to live in the Rocky Mountain region. 12 or 13 of us have played together now for 8 to 10 years. We just have a good time.
Keep it down.
What Tom does is he doesn't care if we make mistakes. He doesn't get down on anybody.
A lot of these players depend on Tom Dater for their life insurance.
It's all teamwork. It's, you know, no individual players.
He's been on their team for 10 years and with New York Life for 18 years.
Why would I buy insurance from a stranger when I can buy it from the worst fullback in Boise?
New York Life, the company you keep.
The Los Angeles Rams, the NFL's only unbeaten team, take their perfect record into Buffalo to meet the Bills on ABC's Monday Night Football.
Commissioner Faye Vincent, and he is seated next to Bart Giamatti's widow, Tony, the series dedicated to the memory of the late commissioner. Looking on, game one as we go to the 8th inning. 5-0, Dave Stewart sailing along with Kennedy at the plate, Uribe and Butler to follow. Mike Lacoste is up in the Giants bullpen. And the count, 2 balls and no strikes. One of the rare times tonight, ball three. Ken Olbrich, fellow at 18 pinch hits this season, is out on deck to bat for Uribe. Lacoste, with his jacket, is on his way back to the Giants dugout. So he has warmed up and probably will come in. There's Mike in the bottom of the 8th inning. Grounded toward the middle. Phillips is over there to backhand it. Throw him out. One away in the 8th inning, and Ken Olbrichfeld comes up. Monday Night Football, Rich Stadium in Buffalo will be the site. Minus Kelly, the Bills trying to get squared away under Frank Reich, and Jim Everett leading the Rams into Buffalo. The Rams, the only unbeaten team through the first 5 weeks. Meanwhile, tomorrow, game 2 here. Big Daddy Rick Russell pitching for San Francisco. Mike Moore for Oakland. 8 Eastern and 5 Pacific tomorrow. Game 2. Obergefell first appeared in a World Series back in 82 as a member of the Cardinals. Came over from Pittsburgh in May. And he's been a terror off the bench for Roger Craig. 2-1.
Yeah, 18 pinch hits.
There is Big Daddy in the background. 40-year-old Russell. 2-2.
Great line. Russell doesn't say very much. And somebody said, gee, you know, you got a lot in common with Nolan Ryan, both of you guys being over 40. He said, anybody that thinks I have anything in common with Nolan Ryan's got to have mush for brains.
Full three to Obergefell, 3-2.
I'll tell you, even though the A's are firmly in control tonight, a lot of guys like Russell, after their teams have lost the opening game, have come back as the second pitcher to work three games of a World Series and win three games. Mm-hmm. The name that pops to my mind, a guy that pitched against us when I was with the Cardinals in the 1968 World Series, Mickey Lolich. Mm-hmm. Started game two after McLean lost game one. That was the day Bob Gibson struck out 17, the World Series record. And Lolich went on to win three ball games. And he was a similar pitcher to Russell, a sinker baller, a guy of portly frame.
Meanwhile, as Stewart issues his first walk of the night and falls behind here 1-0. The righty is Gene Nelson. The lefty is Rick Honeycutt. And La Russa eyeing Stewart carefully. One out and a 1-0 pitch is in there for a strike. 1-1 on Butler.
Now you got to think Russell would have started probably the first game if he had been healthy. Again, the groin pull. He's a leading winner for the Giants. 17 wins. Great sinker. Great changeup. Great breaking ball. Right at the knees.
2-1 the count.
He really matches well against Oakland. A lot of right-handed hitters.
Butler fouling it back toward us in the count. Two balls and two strikes. Stewart tonight walking just one, striking out four. He's faced only five men over the minimum. Started the All-Star game in Anaheim.
First time as an All-Star this year, which is unbelievable considering the fact he's won 20 or more 3 years in a row.
In the air to left field, Henderson over toward the line. And that's the second out. Obergefell remains at first, and the batter will be Robbie Thompson. So two down, Thompson coming to the plate. A's breaking out on top with three in the second tonight. Sending eight men to the plate off Scott Garrelts. Key play in the inning. Kennedy dropping Clark's throw at home plate for an error, allowing a run to score. Parker and Weiss have hit home runs. Stewart has been dominant. And it all adds up to a 5-0 Oakland lead in the eighth inning. Thompson ducks under it. The count 1-0. On deck.
Missed, almost hit him with a split finger, and then comes back again with the same pitch. You can see it just going down. Robbie Thompson swinging right over the top of it.
Looking for a fastball, and the count 2-1.
Yeah, well, he's a dead red hitter. Boy, wants the ball up around the letters. And if you watch the playoffs or the regular season, he can go downtown. You got to think down, right around the knees.
Good fastball in the count 2-2.
Again, we talked, as you look at Dennis Eckersley, the stopper for Oakland. One thing about Dave Stewart, his ball has so much movement. Forget velocity, it just runs, that they'll have guys chasing balls almost over their heads.
Crowd chanting, Stew, as Thompson grounds one on a hop to Lansford. Over to second to Phillips, and the Giants finished in the eighth. 5-0, Oakland.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Amy, I hear your new teacher's real mean.
Amy, would you come up here and bring your picture with you, please?
Mean trouble. Look at the picture.
There's a special power that can bring students and teachers closer together. The power to be your best.
Hey, how's your new teacher?
Oh, she's okay.
Here's a great idea. This Halloween, greet the monsters at your door with Happy Halloween certificates from McDonald's. They're 10 for a dollar. The neighborhood gang can turn them in for free McDonald's dessert treats like cones and sample-size sundaes. You can count on a safe Halloween with Happy Halloween certificates from McDonald's. Now that's using your head.
Several years ago, Lexus engineers took a long, hard look at the sports sedans of Europe and were so underwhelmed, they decided to create one of their own with luxuries the others lacked, such as bird's-eye maple, a six-speaker stereo, even an airbag. Introducing the Lexus ES250, the luxury sedan of sports sedans. Lexus, the result of our relentless pursuit of perfection.
Hey, check out the old timer.
Come on, will you? Come on! I got it!
That was the chance of a lifetime.
I know.
Buy that man a Miller beer.
Hey, see if you can hang on to this.
The best comes shining.
Hi, I'm Will Clark with the San Francisco Giants, and my favorite show on ABC is MacGyver on Monday nights.
Catch MacGyver Mondays on ABC.
For the Giants, Ken Obergefell, who pinch it stays in the game, plays third, hitting in the number nine spot. They move Matt Williams over to shortstop. And going to the mound is Mike Lacoste, who had to leave one of the playoff games with a knee injury. And so he will test it here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Walt Weiss to lead off, then Ricky Henderson and Carney Lansford, and the pitch is taken by Weiss for a strike. 0-1. Lacoste, one of those who is sort of half penciled in for a fourth game on Wednesday night at Candlestick. It's grounded to the right side, and Robbie Thompson will take care of it. One away. We say half penciled in because Roger Craig can go a lot of different ways right now. I think a lot of it will depend on where the series stands at that point, whether he would bring Garrelts back or go with Lacoste or just what.
Well, they played the simulated games, as you look at Roger, and so did Tony La Russa with the A's. And it was a perfect chance to get Lacoste in, give him an inning, get his feet back on the ground, see how his knees is. And I think you're exactly right, Al. Depending on what the situation is as far as wins and losses, that'll dictate who pitches that fourth game.
For the A's, though, they're going to go with a four-man rotation. Tony La Russa committed to that. And what that means, of course, is that Dave Stewart would not pitch games 1, 4, and 7, but 1 and 5 only. And as La Russa said yesterday, he said, hey, if I go to a seventh game, I've got Bob Welch, and that's not bad. 2-0.
I think another piece as you look at Dave Stewart, he used to be Dave Smoke Stewart, but since he got away from that nickname of Smoke, he's been a better pitcher. Another good piece of news as you see Dave's mom. Oh, that's nice. Nice hat.
Look at that button.
Great lid. Her son's picture on the hat. But another good piece of news from the Giants quarters yesterday was Don Robinson pitching batting practice and very successfully, no problem with his right knee. And for that reason, Roger Craig has named him as the number three starter Tuesday night in Candlestick. National League's best hitting pitcher. So
right.
When we get away from the DH for games 3, 4, and 5, if it is played, just a slight edge. You would think so. Only problem is they're facing Bob Welch, and the Giants have never beaten Welch at Candlestick. 19-4 lifetime against San Francisco. Something like 6-0 at Candlestick Park.
Yeah, right. Three balls, two strikes on Henderson. And Ricky Gunn on strikes. That's the second time he has fanned tonight. So Henderson 2-for-5 on the evening as he goes back. Two down, and Carney Lansford is the batter.
Third baseman, Carney Lansford.
Funny World Series in the sense it's the first time in 33 years nobody has to stay in a hotel. Players go home tonight. Put in for toll money tomorrow. Soft one hopper toward the bag at second, and behind it is Thompson to throw Lansford out. So Lacoste has a 1-2-3 inning, and we go to the ninth. It remains 5-0 A's.
Never agree on a restaurant, right?
Hey, I ordered already. I found us a great wine.
Oh, a decision maker.
Oh, this is wonderful wine. I had this at David's.
I served this at my place. It was a big hit.
Oh, you guys, I was hoping you hadn't tried it yet.
Oh, come on. Look, we finally found something we all agree on, you know? I mean, when was the last time that happened?
Ernest and Julio Gallo invite you to try White Grenache. It will change the way you think about Gallo.
Hi, Tim.
Dan got sick. You're going to Paris.
Paris?
AT&T International Service.
Blocking off streets all over Paris. My flight gets in at 7:15 a.m.
Whoa, whoa, 50 Tim, years ago. Look what we forgot. What are we going to tell them?
This is Paris. And I'm Tim Harris reporting. And down below, the horse guards are forming for the Bastille Day Parade.
Colonel, are you setting the route for the parade, or are you in the parade?
I have paid the parade.
Remember, honey, my parents got married in Paris.
What if I find the restaurant in the wedding photo?
This thing doesn't have any name on the restaurant.
That's all right. I'll find it. Just fax me the photo.
We're at the Bastille, where it all started 200 years ago. Fine music.
Mom, I know how to do this.
Fax for you.
John, I'll call you back.
Où est restaurant?
Can you guys make it?
Hello.
John, look, you're going to have to cut me a bigger hole back here. I'm getting some incredible stuff.
Yes, yes, yes. This is my father, and this is me, the little boy.
It's Tim calling us from Paris.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Tim.
Hang on, I've got Kathy on a conference call with us.
Now, Dad,
we want to take you and Mom to dinner. It's a little place. French.
Give her a kiss, Dad.
Happy anniversary.
Great. Happy anniversary.
I'm so glad you made that call.
AT&T Long Distance. No one else gives you this remarkable power to manage your world. No one.
Thank you for using AT&T. Like a lightning rod.
Are you feeling okay?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Life goes on tomorrow.
Rebecca!
Followed by the World Series.
Philadelphia Athletics World Series shutouts. Chief Bender, 1905, against the New York Giants. Earnshaw and Grove combined in 1930. And then Earnshaw in 1931. And none since. Stewart, though, is three outs away as Will Clark leads off in the bottom of the ninth. Top of the ninth. Clark, Mitchell, and Williams. And that's grounded into center field. So Will Clark trying to get something started as his second hit. And he's hit the ball sharply on two other occasions tonight. His liner to center in the first and his double to right in the sixth.
Matter of fact, Stewart has not pitched a shutout this year.
Mike Gallego now plays second base, and they move Tony Phillips over to third. And, of course, what that does is it gives Carney Lansford the rest of the night off with a tender hamstring. Matt, or Kevin Mitchell, it's a fly ball in the shallow right center field, and coming in, Canseco can't make the catch. Clark had to hold up and now pulls in at second. So Will, halfway between first and second, had to wait. Canseco can't make the play, and the Giants stir in the ninth with runners at first and second and nobody out.
And again, the opposite fielder gets burned, this time Fransicso. You remember earlier in the game, Mark McGuire looping a single in front of Candy Maldonado. And now it's Canseco's turn. A nice try by Jose. But it's first and second Giants. The first time tonight that they have had two consecutive hits. As a matter of fact, it's the first time they've had two men on base in an inning.
Stewart says the magic words to La Russa, so he stays in the bullpen. Rick Honeycutt, the lefty, Gene Nelson, the righty. Here's another look.
Got a long run for Canseco. Stewart around in left center. Excuse me, the Henderson around in left center for Mitchell, who's a pull hitter. One guy had a chance, and he couldn't come up with it.
Matt Williams, hitless in three trips. 1-0. To be reminded about the bottom of the ninth inning or the end of the game in the opening game of the World Series. Just go back a year, of course, a different circumstance then, trying to protect the one-run lead and the classic confrontation and home run by Gibson with two out and two strikes, and the Dodgers were on their way.
Surprising thing, Al, is both Nelson and Honeycutt still up, and Eckersley, the stopper, with 33 saves last year, 45, still resting on the bench. I was a little surprised to see that too. Long ball here makes it a two-run ball game.
One ball, two strikes. The only thing I can think of is that the way La Russa uses Eckersley, he never wants to get him up if he's not going to use him. And so he figures, I still have a five-run lead. I've got the two guys in the bullpen. It's really not time to get him up. He's, I don't know if I'm going to get him in. Which makes a lot of sense, of course, during the regular season. But here, keep in mind, I mean, Eckersley still hasn't pitched in 5 days to begin with. And Williams got on strike. Split and down he goes, and that's strikeout number five for Stewart.
Again, you can see the tumbling action, but what Stewart would like, he'll take the strikeout, but with the forkball, the split finger fastball, the motion is down, usually hit the top half. Would have liked to have had a double play, but certainly will settle for the strikeout.
Riles the batter, and the count is 0-1. So Williams, a long night for Williams, 0-4. And Riles at the plate with two on and one out. One and one.
The thing that makes Stewart so tough is the different planes. You got the forkball going down, you got the fastball taking off. He'll turn some over. I was not being facetious when I said that he has dropped his nickname of Dave Smoke Stewart, because I think one of his problems earlier in his career, he tried to live up to the nickname of Smoke Stewart and throw the ball too hard. Now, as you can plainly see, he's much more of a pitcher with, as Jim says, the change of speeds, the different planes.
Well, you know, when you become a thrower, Jim, it's very much like hitting. They talk about Will Clark, tension-free swing. Well, you got to be able to throw the ball tension-free. Get it out on your fingertips. Get that good movement. If you try to throw it too hard, it goes too straight.
And that one gets by Steinbach as Clark moves gingerly into third and Mitchell down to second.
Looked like he may have crossed Steinbach up. with the fastball inside. Usually if that happens, the catcher will go out and talk to his pitcher. But the ball, on the other hand, could have sailed on Terry. That's where a lot of pass balls come on catchers. It hasn't been scored yet. But a lot of your pass balls come on balls that you have to reach for. Catchers don't move quickly enough for the glove. Try to get in front of it.
2-2 to Riles is fouled away.
That's overrated anyway. People talk about catchers trying to get in front of 92-mile-an-hour fastballs. It was a pass ball, as you see. I have never been a proponent of catchers getting in front of everything unless they're blocking the ball. Bill Dickey told me one time that a catcher never becomes a good catcher until he starts catching with one hand.
He lived up to his old nickname there. Six strikeouts. That was a pretty good little operation. A little off-speed stuff, change, and then see you around.
And again, maybe that wild pitch or the pass ball, I guess, as it was scored, sets that up. You come way inside, the hitter a little different perspective. He hasn't come in very often on left-handers tonight.
Two out, crowd chanting, Stew, Stew, Stew. The runner at third, and Mitchell at second.
Two and one. Again, you talked about the nickname Smoke right here. And the courage to throw it over 2-0. Maldonado knows what's coming. I mean, everybody knows 2-0 with a five-run lead. You're going to challenge the hitter. He did that. Foul ball.
Three and one the count. Is out on deck. Two on, two out. And it's grounded to third. Backhanded by Phillips. Straightens up and Stewart has his shutout. So in a World Series dedicated to a late scholar, game one is all A's. Final score, game one. Oakland 5, San Francisco nothing.
I got dirty an awful lot when I was little.
What am I doing here? You know this.
You're playing baseball.
Yeah, that's right.
It came natural to get dirty. Johnson's baby shampoo has been great for my hair all through my life. It's strong. It makes my hair look clean. It makes my hair feel clean, and it's gentle. Look at this kid's hair. I think it looks good.
Johnson's baby shampoo, now also with conditioners for extra control.
I shower 4 or 5 times a day. It's never made me cry.
Johnson's, for the life of your hair.
One of these guys is a pro photographer. One's a dentist.
With the autofocus EOS 750, it's tough to tell them apart. Canon EOS. Now you don't have to be a pro to shoot like one. And with the EOS 750, now you don't have to be a pro to afford one. Autofocus Canon EOS. So advanced, it's easy to shoot like a pro.
By the way, Doc,
what's that?
Could you look at this tooth?
Now, a $50 rebate direct from Canon.
You can imagine this tower was 300 feet tall. And when it hit his house, and then you see how it flattened the metal. So we got a real good whip out of it.
Hurricane Hugo surprised many people. Allstate's catastrophe team was ready.
With Allstate coming and the adjuster coming as quickly as he did, I think you need them. I really think you need to have a good insurance company like Allstate. Allstate came through when they had to. And I'm glad we have it.
When you've got diarrhea, you can take this. And when you're in real trouble, now you can choose maximum strength Pepto-Bismol. Twice the medicine, twice the Pepto. Ah. Tomorrow.
Rebecca's father.
Yes, sir.
We can't lock her up. Can we lock her up?
Life goes on.
Rebecca!
Tomorrow.
Parker and Weiss hit home runs. McGuire has three hits. Henderson has two, but the night belongs to Dave Stewart. He pitches a shutout, and he's with Gary Thorne. Gary?
Thank you. Well, Dave, magnificent performance. Congratulations. You said you were concerned about early innings because sometimes you run into trouble early. You got out of it tonight.
Well, it's always my main concern, early innings, because, you know, I do have problems in the early part of ball game. If I can get past the first three innings, then usually I can sail the last five or six innings. And, you know, if I have to go to the bullpen, I feel that I'm pretty safe.
You pitch a lot of innings in the course of a season, but you get back into that 90-mile-an-hour range in that last inning.
Well, it was a necessity for a little extra in that last inning. I wanted to shut out, and the only way I could figure to go about getting it is to strike a couple guys out, especially after a pass ball, and see what happens.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Stewart, winning pitcher of the shutout, and Joe Morgan.
Roger, Dave Stewart shut your hitters down today. Did he show you anything different than you expected?
No, they said he'd come out just with his fastball, and we got ahead, he'd go to split finger, and he had a both. He had a good fastball, and he maintained his fastball throughout the ball game and had a good split finger. He didn't throw too many sliders, but he pitched out a big jam there in the ninth inning. You got to give him credit. He did a great job.
Well, you guys have come back from adversity so far this season.
We've done it a lot of times, and, you know, this is just one ball game. We've got a lot of games to go. You just got to give Dave Stewart and the A's credit. They beat us tonight.
Good luck tomorrow. Okay. Back up to you, Al.
All right, thank you, Joe. So Dave Stewart is the man. He goes all the way. The final score is 5-0 in game one, and we'll come back to Oakland in just a moment.
We're here on a spot check at our distributor in Meridian, Mississippi. It gets pretty chilly here in the storeroom. Bless you, Ed. But folks here like to keep Bartles and James as cool and fresh as the day we make it. While this is good for our coolers, it is not so good for photography. But it makes sure none of the quality we put into coolers like our new premium blush gets lost before it gets to you. And a cooler cooler is a better tasting cooler. Thank you for your support.
You can imagine this tower was 300 feet tall. And when it hit his house, and then you see how it flattened the metal. So we got a real good whip out of it.
Hurricane Hugo surprised many people. Allstate's catastrophe team was ready.
With Allstate coming and the adjuster coming as quickly as he did, I think you need them. I really think you need to have a good insurance company like Allstate. Allstate came through when they had to. And I'm glad we have it.
Weekends at my morning place, I like to take it slow. Get my breakfast fast, then I'll make it last. It's the best time that I know. Relaxing with a good time. Great taste. You know there's only one place for my weekend McMorning. McDonald's.
It's always Rebecca.
My spine felt like a lightning rod.
Are you feeling okay?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yours are pretty weird.
Life goes on.
Rebecca!
following the World Series tomorrow.
Monday.
Are you ready, Buffalo football?
The undefeated Los Angeles Rams tackle the Buffalo Bills on ABC's NFL Monday Night Football.
Then on Bangkok's black market, everything has a price.
You come looking for more trouble?
Not really. You're gonna die, pal.
MacGyver.
A's got three in the second. Dave Parker hit this home run in the third inning. Walt Weiss hit a home run in the fourth. And Dave Stewart pitches the shutout. And game one belongs to Oakland. 5-0. Al Michaels for Jim Palmer, Tim McCarver saying good night from Oakland. With a reminder that tomorrow night on ABC Sports, we're back at the Oakland-Alameda County Coliseum for Game 2 of the 1989 World Series between the San Francisco Giants and the Oakland A's. Our coverage begins live at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. And Monday night on ABC's Monday Night Football, Jim Everett and the undefeated Los Angeles Rams try to go 6-0 as they battle the Buffalo Bills live at 9 Eastern time. Aerial facilities provided by the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company. See you tomorrow night.
The 1989 World Series, the San Francisco Giants versus the Oakland Athletics, has been brought to you by Miller High Life. By That Man of Miller, the best comes shining through. By AT&T, the right choice. By Diet Pepsi, for great taste that's a home run every time, it's Diet Pepsi, the right one. And by Lexus Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.